on a gray, cold day in Manhattan, Kansas. We're getting ready for a good one out of the Big 12 as Colorado takes on number 8 Kansas State. Hi and welcome, everybody. Along with Tim Brandt, I'm Terry Gannon. Colorado comes in needing a win to be eligible for a bowl game. Kansas State hopes to make the Alliance party. And, Timmy, they've been getting it done on the magic of their quarterback, Michael Bishop.
No question about it, Terry. I'm excited to see Michael Bishop play again. He's a phenomenal athlete. Great runner, strong arm. The guy just does not lose. He won 2 national championships without a loss in junior college. Now at Kansas State, his only loss is to Nebraska. Still has hopes of that Alliance Bowl, so today is a must-win situation. Colorado's quarterback is John Hessler. He's been inconsistent at times, but he had his greatest moment in this stadium 2 years ago, coming from behind to win. He needs early success to build his confidence today, but he could be the difference in this ball game. For more on Colorado's defense, let's go down on the field. Here's Lewis Johnson.
Timmy, there has been a lot of discussion this week about the return of Colorado linebacker Ron Merkerson. You know, he's been out since the third game of the season with torn up ligaments in his right knee. He is the leader of the Colorado defense, and without him, they've really struggled. Now, during pregame warmups, I saw him warm up. He looked pretty good. He had good forward and backward movements. Lateral movements were okay. But if you ask me, I don't think he's quite 100%.
But that's fine, though, Lewis. It's a psychological thing for the entire defense. I think Rick Neuheisel knows the defense needs a spark. He's the guy that can do it. He also knows the packages, can make some calls, run some blitzes. It's important that he's willing to play and has the ability physically to get in the ball game and play some today with that defense.
Offensively, Colorado's been much better in the last 4 games, but they've got to stay away from the turnover. Now, Kansas State won the toss. They defer to the second half. There is a brisk wind out of the north, and the wind chill is going to get to about 15 or 20. That is it. And don't miss any of the kickoffs. Whatever you do, you've got the top 2 return men and teams in the country. Number 1, Ben Kelly, the top man in the nation. Almost 35 yards per return. He's back there along with Damon Wheeler.
Both teams have great special teams, and of course, field position in a game like this, always important.
They tell us it's 33 degrees. I don't believe them. It feels like it's in single digits. Snow flurries in the forecast. So Jamie Ream gets us underway here in Manhattan. Ben Kelly, 2 yards deep. He's going to bring it out. Got a wedge in front of him. Got a seam across the 30 to midfield. And finally brought down at the 49 of Kansas State. You get a look at the best return man in all of college football.
To be a great return man, you need several things. Number 1, first and foremost, is speed. Then you need vision. You need a lot of guts, too. No question what he was going to do. He was bringing it out. Now he's patient, sees a seam. Now he burst into that second explosion. Look at this. He's looking for help now, looking for a blocker. But by stumbling there for a second, he allowed the tackler, Niesman, to get up and make that stop.
And Gerald Niesman is the second best return man in all of college football. Had a 99-yarder last week against Kansas. He made the tackle. Michelle Troutman trying the right side. Got a lane and a good gain on first down. Out to the 43-yard line of Kansas State. Take a look at the chilly starting lineups and this offensive line for Colorado banged up because of those injuries. Wells starting at center. Cook goes to tackle. Phil Savoy is back after missing last week's game with a shoulder injury that's bothered him all season long. And in the backfield, you've got Troutman as well as John Hessler, who has played better in the last 4 games, but he's got to stay away from the mistakes. Even last week against Iowa State, had an interception go all the way back 94 yards and a fumble on a pitch. But here he connects. It's complete to Marcus Stiggers. A big gain inside the 25 all the way down to the 19-yard line. And what about this Colorado offense right out of the gate, Timmy?
Well, it's an offense that loves to throw. They throw a great deal. They like to use that to set up the run, and they're going against a freshman here. This guy is Carter. He's been on the corner, and he's the guy they've been picking on and will throughout the day. Good move, go right by 35, Carter. Now you're going to see Colorado now use that pass effectively, but they're going to go after this freshman quite a bit. They have the last several games tried to pick a weak spot. Coming in, this was the one they thought would work.
And a double tight end set right now. Desmond Dennis at end. Tight end for the Buffaloes. The give straight ahead to Herschel Troutman. Rochelle gets about two. That is it. He goes against the defense in Kansas State that has traditionally, over the last 4 or 5 years, been one of the best in the country. Darren Howard, a young sophomore, but they love him here. He is so talented, puts a lot of pressure on the quarterbacks. And this may be one of the most unheralded, but one of the best linebacking corps in the entire country. The secondary, though, today will be tested. You got a couple of redshirt freshmen back there. Troutman picked up about three on first down, so it's second and seven at the 16. Troutman again looking for a lane, but Travis Oakes closes quickly and brings him down.
You know, Colorado's gotten off to shaky starts the last several ball games, especially last week. They had to come from behind again and win. Here is a very good drive, but now they're faced with third down and short. It's going to be critical that they pick up the first down here. Right now, Rick Neuheisel and the Buffaloes want to get a touchdown, obviously, and not the field goal. If they can do that, we'll see how they react with the lead over a top-ranked team like Kansas State.
Neuheisel 25-8 in his first two seasons. Different year this year, though. Severini in motion to the far side. Wayne Charlington, the lone setback. Throw out to Severini, and he can't pick it up. It was a little bit behind him, and he would have been close to the first down if he would have caught that.
A little bit behind him and a little bit low. Skipped it out to him. He was open. He had enough for the first down. Hessler just had to put that ball there, and they'll have to settle for three.
And there's a look at Rick Neuheisel talking to his quarterback, and they've done a lot of that this year on the sideline. Obviously under the gun all season, not the season Hessler had hoped for. And here's Jeremy Aldridge trying to put the first points on the board. 29-yard field goal try. Plenty of distance, and it is good. So the Buffaloes off the long return by Ben Kelly, 52 yards after bringing it back against Kansas State. That sets up the opening field goal, and it is 3-0 in Manhattan.
When you try Chili's Ranch Hand Filet, a beautifully carved 8-ounce tenderloin, slow grilled to perfection and placed on awesome blossom strings. Served with skillet potato cakes and grilled veggies, only at Chili's.
If you ever end up in some Ben-Hur movie, in your Pontiac Sunfire GT, with its powerful twin cam engine, well, you'll be glad you have a quick-handling sports suspension. And, of course, 150 horses. The Pontiac Sunfire GT. Finally, a real set of wheels you can really afford.
America has always had a love affair with cars. And since 1922, we've been there whenever you've needed us. That's why we're America's favorite auto insurer.
And as we celebrate a 75th year, we, the agents
and employees of State Farm,
would just like to say thanks for being there, too.
The Skins Game, where four hungry guys go out to shoot birdies. Some come back with lots of stuffing. Others only get heartburn. That's why they play it on Thanksgiving weekend.
The opening drive successful for the Buffaloes. They get on the board with a 29-yard field goal and lead it 3-0. Much of that due to the return of Ben Kelly. And here's a look at Gerald Niesman, the number two return man in the entire country. This is what he's done this year, and two explosive teams in terms of returns, not only kickoff but punting as well.
Niesman also made the critical tackle on the big return by Kelly.
So Aldridge will pooch it. A high, short kick, trying to keep it away from Niesman, and it's taken at the 34-yard line.
Smart play to avoid the return, knowing that if they pooch it high, it'll be a fair catch, which it was.
Chili's starting lineups, and this is a huge offensive line. This is the biggest one in college football, bigger than almost everyone in the NFL, as a matter of fact. The wideouts struggled early, but Parise and McDonald have played much better as of late. and the backfield, Eric Hickson, the number one rusher, but Michael Bishop is not far behind. And this guy, every time he touches the football, you look for something spectacular to happen.
Yeah, offensively, K-State gives you a threat of the option. They give you a moderate passing game, but Bishop is always a threat no matter what he does.
Well, it's first down at the 35. And it's Mike Lawrence this time looking for a lane, getting up to about the 38-yard line. You've got Lawrence and Hickson, two pretty good backs. Hickson coming back off that leg injury a year ago. This is the defensive front that they will face. And Rick Neuhaus really challenged this squad last game. Vili Maumau had his best game of the year against Iowa State. Hannibal Navies with 4-4 speed in the 40. He's got great speed. Ty Gregorick, a true freshman. And, of course, Merkerson in there. You heard Lewis Johnson's report. And a secondary for Colorado. So not only do you get maybe your best defensive player back on the field, but a leader. That's a huge lift for this defense. Mike Lawrence, tough running straight ahead for about a yard for the first time this afternoon. Let's check in with John Saunders in New York. A busy day in college football, John.
Indeed, Terry. And Washington in the Pac-10, the only team that controls its own destiny. Beat UCLA and Washington State. They go to the Rose Bowl. Maurice Shaw in for Rashawn Sheehy, who's injured, takes off and takes it to the end zone. And Washington strikes first against UCLA. They lead 7-0. Terry.
All right, Johnny, good one out in the Pac-10. A lot of football left to be played before all the bowl picture is clear. Bishop throws. His tight end Hefner inside the 35 down to the 32-yard line before he's knocked out. That's Justin Swift, the tight end, who makes the catch in a gain of 29.
Everybody was accounted for except the tight end. They came on a blitz, running a 2-deep 5-under. Now watch, he just goes across on a little drag pattern all the way across, and he's big. 6'3", 250 pounds. That's his 11th reception of the year, but watch. They come over, two guys to knock him out of bounds. Here's a guy that was 265 pounds in the Cotton Bowl. He's now thinner and a lot quicker, but they just dragged him across. Nobody picked him up.
Those 10 catches coming in, third leading receiver on this Kansas State team. Matt Gangwish now in at fullback. And it's Mike Lawrence straight ahead, got a big hole. West side, side, and down to the 20-yard line. That offensive line just moving the defensive front of Colorado.
Same thing every game for the Colorado defense. They'll hold you defensively, then they'll give up a big play. I mean, Iowa State got most of its yardage last week on just a few big plays. The defense needs more consistency. They come on a blitz, the linebacker frees up the tight end. Bingo, there's a big one. Then they lay soft, and they run the running back at them. They're playing on their heels a little bit, but then they'll get tough again. They've got to get more consistent.
There goes Bishop. Most of the time when he runs, it's a called play. Gets inside the 20, got a first down at the 17-yard line. This is a guy who, every time he drops back, he is so dangerous. And he told us yesterday, most of the time when he runs, it's something from the sideline.
Now, this was a called draw before it even developed. Now, number one, Ben Kelly will knock him out of bounds. Watch this. Then after the play, the two of them had words. Now, Kelly's not a big guy. He's only 5'9 and a half, 170 pounds, and Bishop's 6'1. And he's over 200 pounds. Those two going face to face on the way back to the huddle. A little trash talking going on.
Michael Bishop is a Texas guy. This has got to be the coldest game he's ever played in. Breeze in motion to the near sideline. There goes Lawrence. Breaking outside. He's got green. There's a flag down. Run out of bounds at the 11-yard line. And there are two flags down now. One back at the 17 behind the line of scrimmage and one right at the point of tackle.
Well, the first flag, I think, is going to be holding. It's going to be holding against Gangwish and Martin.
Holding on the offense. Face mask on the defense. The penalties were offset. Replay first down.
So the offsetting penalties. Hale Dowden letting us know that they'll replay the down. Now what a job that Bill Snyder has done. Maybe as good as any when you look at college football, the turnarounds. He came in here, and there was just no sense of pride or of winning at all in Manhattan. And now he's got them number 8 in the country and maybe their best year yet. Chance to get into an Alliance Bowl. So it's first and 10 at the 17-yard line. Gangwish and Lawrence for the offset on. Bishop, the give to Lawrence. offensive line trying to push the defensive front again. A gain of about 3 down inside the 15.
Mike Lawrence averages over 5 yards a carry. Very dangerous running back. Also a wide receiver, and they'll split him. 5'10", 200-pound senior. Look at this. Third all-time career rushing yards.
Needs 116 to become the all-time leading rusher in K-State history.
Quick feet, nice moves.
He's really accepted his role this year, too. Once again, Eric Hickson coming back off the leg injury, and they've split time at the tailback spot. Second and 8 out of the shotgun. Bishop to run. Watch out. Right at the 14, though. They've got to get all the way down to the 7-yard line for a first down.
Colorado will blitz almost every play. I mean, it seems as if they're blitzing every play. Now, if you watch this, here comes Gregorak now, number 35, right up the middle, and overruns the play. But they're going to bring somebody, whether it's a zone blitz, a run blitz, a pass blitz, or coming off the corner, they're going to do it. Gregorak that time, he just overran the play.
A.J. Kriftoff, the defensive coordinator, said Ty Gregorak has picked things up better than anybody and quicker than anybody he's ever had.
First true freshman to start a middle linebacker since 1991 at CU.
Third down pass. Did he make the catch at the 10? No. Bishop threw it behind him. Couldn't get his footing to make the catch, but he was well short of the first down anyway.
Boy, he moved so well for a big guy. This ball is not really well thrown by Bishop. He felt the pressure coming in the backside. But look at Swift. It was the ground that just knocked it loose at the last second because he had it cuddled in there.
Well, Michael Bishop has been taken out of a couple of games and benched this year, but at this point playing with a lot of confidence. And here is Martin Gramatica, one of the 3 finalists for the Groza Award. Best kicker in all of college football. That award going to a 29-yard field goal try. And we are tied at 3. Shows as much emotion as any kicker in the country, too.
Vacation travelers know that when it comes to renting a car, there's really only one place to go. National Car Rental. Especially if you're planning to go to the Walt Disney World 25th Anniversary Celebration. Because as the official car rental company of Walt Disney World, National gets you in your car and on the road fast. So what are you waiting for? Let's go to the Walt Disney World 25th Anniversary with National Car Rental. But hurry, the celebration ends January 31st.
Trailers for sale or rent, rooms to let 50 cents. Mama, man of means, by no means, king of the road. 2 hours of pushing broom buys an 8-12 4-bedroom. Mama, man of means, by no means, king of the road.
So powerful, it's almost scary. Boo. The muscle car lives. The new Trans Am by Pontiac.
ABC Sports presentation of college football brought to you by CompUSA, the computer superstore. Burger King, where you can get your burgers worth. The legendary Firebird Trans Am from Pontiac and State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. A pair of 29-yard field goals, and we are tied at 3 early on.
A lot of pressure on that freshman right there, Dyshawn Carter. Colorado wants to throw at him. Number one pass defense in the Big 12, but it really hadn't been tested.
Ben Kelly brought it back 53 yards the first time. Here's Benjamin Wheeler going to try to bring it out. Stumbles and falls across the 20 out to the 22-yard line. So Kansas State, at least right now, electing to go ahead and kick off deep, even though you've got Ben Kelly and Wheeler at the goal line awaiting them.
Colorado throws 30 times a game and will test this secondary, which I said has not really been tested. Now, obviously, Kansas State has allowed only 2 touchdown passes all year. But they defended only 161 passes, and this guy right here, Hessler, has completed almost that many himself. They think they have a weak spot. They were successful in the first drive. We'll see if they do it here.
And even though he's thrown 13 interceptions on the year and he's made some mistakes, you know the guy's got a gun. You know he can explode. He's done it in the past.
Here's your matchup.
Play action. A lot of time for Hessler going deep over the middle. No one there. Intended for Cheverini, but he was well covered by Dimitric Denmark. Step for step with Darren Cheverini, the leading receiver on the Buffalo squad.
Savoy, big target, 6'3", 200 pounds. He's the one that was matched up with Carter that time. He's only 5'10".
Savoy coming off that shoulder injury. Did not play a week ago. Troutman, the lone setback. Here they come on the blitz. Hessler picks it up. He had Stingers wide open, but he overthrows him.
Rushed himself. Didn't have to rush that much. Never really set the back foot, but threw, falling away. Watch Hessler this time. Watch how he doesn't set. He almost feels like the blitz is coming and just throws without even setting. Never planted a foot, never threw in rhythm, but was falling away from the receiver when he let it go.
And it was Mark Simoneau coming at him, but it was picked up by the tailback.
Look how this has fallen off over the last couple of years. They were 8th and 10th this year, 44th in the NCAA in passing yards.
Hard to believe with all the expectations coming into the season. So it's 3rd and 10. Hessler with a straight drop. He's had time every time. This one complete to Cheverini. We'll see where they mark it. I don't believe he even got close to a first down, though.
No, not even close, and that is the fault of Cheverini, the receiver. He's got to know where that marker is. The coaches are upset with him. He had to get across the 31-yard line and never even got close to that. He ought to come up, push to the 35, then come back to the football to get the first.
And you look at Neuheisel, that's who he's talking to. He's not talking to his quarterback. He's talking to Darren Cheverini. Nick Peets is on for his first punt of the afternoon. And back deep is David Allen, another dangerous return man. And a 70-yard return for a touchdown against Kansas. This is a short line drive kick, and it bounces out of bounds at the 38-yard line, a 33-yard punt. That's it. Well, next Saturday, America's biggest road show rolls into Ann Arbor. This is a great one. At noon Eastern, number 4 Ohio State taking on number 2 Michigan. The Rose Bowl perhaps on the line.
Could this be the year for Cooper?
To finally beat Michigan? 3:30 Eastern time. You've got a regional lineup. There are the matchups. Check your local listings for the games in your area. Call your cable operator for information on pay-per-view. And we get word from the field that they are looking at Michael Bishop's ankle during the last series. He's back in there. The handoff to Mike Lawrence straight ahead. So Bishop at least okay right now. And let's step away, check in again with John Saunders. John?
Terry, the sandwich game for Michigan between Penn State and Ohio State against a very good Wisconsin team. Trickery here. Brian Greasy to Charles Woodson. Back to the quarterback, Greasy, who takes off and gets it down to the 1-yard line. Then on 4th and goal, Chris Howard with the touchdown. 7-0. Terry.
All right, John, the sandwich games can be very dangerous. An Ohio State game coming up next week. Bishop, the quick out. Darnell McDonald had to go right through his hands, but he was really well covered by Marcus Washington.
Bishop was hit just as he released it, too. Got a lot of zip on it. The ball is actually well thrown, but watch the pressure they put on Bishop this time. Now they're coming with a little twist. Now watch, just as he releases it, he gets a hand right there on his shoulder. Still got off a good pass. Now watch this. Here comes your receiver, McDonald. The ball's well thrown, but good coverage by Washington, 37.
Michael Bishop, we told you they were looking at his ankle. They're heavily taped, I'll tell you that.
He hurt his ankle against Texas A&M. He's really now just coming around. They said he's almost to 100% this game, but he got it dinged early on.
Ryan Black on the blitz. They had Bishop. They don't have him anymore. Throws it all the way downfield to the end zone. It's incomplete. Burnett was there. But you get a look at the arm and the mobility of Michael Bishop.
Good coverage by Wheeler to stay with him the whole time. Burnett was trying to get back to Bishop. Two guys miss him. One, two. He's still. Now he has time to set. Set and fires. But I want you to look at number two. Stays with him and runs right in Burnett's hip pocket. That's Wheeler. Great coverage by him to stay with him.
James Garcia with the punt. And Wheeler on the fair catch inside the 10-yard line. So they'll mark it just outside the 7. And a 54-yard punt. Michael Bishop on the sideline. Ankle looks all right so far. Buffaloes take over inside their 10.
If you ever take your Pontiac Sunfire driving through some famous expressionist painting, it'll fit right in. Because it looks like a work of art, right? And it drives like a real scream. Pontiac Sunfire. Finally, a real set of wheels you can really afford.
New family members mean new responsibilities and new needs for life insurance protection. Why not drop in on your MetLife representative, who will help make sense of it all for you, Mama, and your family? Get Met. It pays.
There are millions of reasons to fly today. Only one that matters to you. At Delta Airlines, it is our pleasure to get you to the place you want to be. Delta Airlines, on top of the world.
3-3 ball game, 5:55 left in the first. What about the decision by Damon Wheeler to field that punt inside the 10, Timmy?
Terry, they say never field a ball inside the 10-yard line. Sometimes you feel if you've got some room, you may try to gamble a little bit, try to take it, and try to make a return on it. But Damon Wheeler that time, you're looking at him right here, he really wasn't pressured that much. Still fair caught it and did it inside the 10. Gives Colorado very poor field position. We told you the kicking game is going to be big today. Field position is certainly going to be big among these two teams. Right now, that advantage goes to K-State.
Really cost them about 13 yards. They would have started at the 20 had that ball gotten to the end zone. Listen to this crowd here at Kansas State Stadium. Charrington runs outside. He turned the corner. And a big gain of first down before he's ridden out of bounds. Across the 20. Dwayne Charrington, the sophomore out of Santa Ana, California, on the carry.
Boy, I tell you what, he has shown tremendous speed to get around that corner. They have really had success on first down all year. Now, I think this is the most important down in football. You always hear about third down conversions, but look at this. They average over 6 yards every time on first down.
Hessler taking a look at the defense. Straight ahead, they go over the left side. Charrington again, this time he's wrapped up after a gain of about 2, maybe 3.
Trying to power game, bringing Thomas and Johannigmeier around on the counter tray. Pulled their guard and tackle that time to get around in front of him. Trying a little power game. He'll come back and pass, though. This will be second down and long. And that's exactly where Hessler and Neuhaus will like to throw. Matter of fact, he's already reading the defense. Looking for his target.
Harrington, the lone setback. Three receiver set. Give it to the running back. Charrington is locked up behind the line of scrimmage. Well, Mike Stoops, the defensive coordinator for Kansas State, said their priority was to stop the run first.
Well, I tell you what, that play surprised him. He came up, he looked at things. Now, Rowe will make this tackle, but look, it's just a off-tackle play on second down and 9. That's a play normally they will throw on. They're breaking tendency a little bit, trying to mix things up for Kansas State. They weren't fooled.
Third and 9. You got to believe they're going to run the play action and throw here. You've got three receivers. Straight drop. Hessler with time. Receiver was held for a moment and it's incomplete. Boy, a lot of contact near the 40-yard line. Robert Toler was the intended receiver, and he couldn't get to the football.
That ball's well thrown, but I'm telling you, the coverage is even better than that. Look at this. They're in man coverage all the way. Denmark's number 29. He's using his hands, using his body. He almost had the interception. That would have been a great pick. They were playing a two deep five under man-to-man coverage, and they had him all the way. There's a look at Mike Stoops, defensive coordinator. He was a great defensive back in his day, All-American.
Brother, of course, the defensive coordinator at Florida. Not having the kind of year they expected or wanted. And Andy Mitchell has come on after that first punt by Nick Peach, which was not a good one. David Allen watching this one fall short as well. Takes a bit of a Colorado bounce, but it's only a 34-yard punt this time.
Kansas State started the offense last time at the 38, then gave it back and pinned Colorado inside the 10. Now they're going to start at the 43-yard line.
Now tomorrow at 1:30 Eastern time, 12:30 Central, the U.S. national soccer team hosts El Salvador. The U.S. will go to the World Cup. They've already qualified, but El Salvador still trying to do just that tomorrow on ABC at 12:30 Central time. So Bill Snyder's club at its own 39. That's where they have started in terms of the average so far. Good field position. Goolsby and Eric Hickson in there as somebody moved. It may have been Justin Swift, the tight end on the right side. Sort it out.
Dead ball. False start on the offense. Still first down.
Very rare you see an offensive lineman jump like that. I mean, this is an offensive line that is huge, 6'4", 315 pounds. You talked about their size. Only the Redskins and Jaguars in the National Football League are bigger.
Isn't that amazing?
They call themselves the tank. They roll over people. But more importantly, they've got great feet and they're very disciplined. It's very rare to see them make a mistake like that where they'll jump and get the penalty.
Kendall Jaycox, the center, a senior out of Dallas, goes about 320. He's a good one. Eric Hickson out to the outside, got a big hole across midfield to the 48-yard line. So you're going to look at Hickson. Mike Lawrence started the ball game, and now the senior out of Fort Lauderdale, Florida, with the carry and a gain of 13.
Anytime you run the option, it breaks you down to assignment defense. Bishop does this well. You have to respect the run. Stop it right there. He's already tied up here. Okay, so then you want to get it outside. Now, he's got to get up and make the stop on the pitch man, but he's blocked. They make that play. They make it work. Bishop's the guy you want to watch. They've got to get up and take the pitch man as well.
Blocked and maybe held a little bit, too. A little extra going up. There goes Hickson on the option to the near side. With a 43-yard line, got a first down for the Wildcats. So they run it left, they run it right. And they'll move the chains. Over 600 yards on the year for Hickson, the number one rusher. But he and Lawrence are a great 1-2 punch.
You know, I think being 5'8" actually helps him. He's hard to find. The offensive line, we told you, is huge, 6'4", 316. Behind that big offensive line, he hides. He's a hide-and-seek runner. He'll hide behind the big guys. He'll seek a hole, and when he finds it, he explodes.
You saw that with Warrick Dunn at Florida State, now in the NFL. It's just tough to find him, especially when you got that huge offensive line you're trying to get past. Throws to near the tight end in motion. Hickson got a lane to run through. This time getting outside, and Sutter runs it out of bounds at the 38.
Ball carry number 24, Eric Hickson.
And the first three plays
run of out of bounds
drive,
by number 36, Ryan Sutter.
They've been running left, running right, and the offensive line blowing huge gaps in that defensive front.
There's a situation that we just talked about. You take Martin, he's a 500-pound bench press guy. He's 305 pounds. He's the right guard. So you pull him, you put him in front of Hickson, and Hickson just follows him up there for 5 yards.
51 yards on the ground already for Bill Snyder's club. Second and six, they give it to Goolsby this time. The fullback, you hear the Ghoul chant here in the crowd. Tough running inside the 35.
He's a great changeup runner, too. You come back off of Hickson, who's real small but real quick, and now you bring in Goolsby, who's 250 pounds, and he's a true power back and a great changeup runner.
Much better rushing the football this year is Kansas State.
They were last in the conference last year in the run game. That's really changed now with Bishop and that huge offensive line.
Made it a priority, too. That's what they wanted to do when they started the year. Bishop can't get anywhere this time, though. They tried the option to the near side. He kept it. And he was just swarmed under. Brady McDonald, a redshirt freshman, hit him.
Watch how quickly they get on him this time, though. They don't give him much of a chance to option the ball because he sees the pressure coming from the outside by 82 McDonald. He doesn't really have a chance to get out, and so he tries to cut it up, and everybody's there.
McDonald played nine-man football back in Quinn, South Dakota. Only 75 people in his hometown, and they're going to try a 52, almost a 53-yard field goal. Gramatica hit a 56-yarder in pregame. We were watching it. This one, 20 of leg, and it's good. Martin Gramatica stating his case for the Grozo Award. Two-yard field goal by Martin Gramatica.
You think that doesn't make a difference when you've got a guy that's going to put points on the board from almost midfield? This is incredible. Watch his plant foot. It's firm. Boom. He follows through like a great golfer. Now watch his emotion. This is a guy that loves the game of football. He knows it's good, and look at him. Boy, what a weapon that is to have in your arsenal.
You don't see that reaction from a golfer, though. He may look like he's kicking the football, but... Wow, look at the three finalists, including Sims Linhart from Duke, Chris Taylor at UCLA. But Gramatica has the best percentage out of all of them, and he's improving his case today.
Duke had a female kicker for a while. Remember that? She actually, I believe, filed suit. But here's Linhart now as a finalist for the award.
Well, special teams certainly one of the big parts of any game, but really this game, because Kansas State has been so good in terms of that, and both teams have great return men. And so far, we've got three field goals on the board.
Yeah, and all that means field position, and so far Kansas State has had that advantage. Consequently, they lead on the scoreboard 2-1.
And Kelly did give Colorado great field position on the opening return, though. Not going to do it this time. Ream sends it out of the end zone, and the Buffs will have to bring it out to the 20 to start their drive. Well, ABC's college football is online live with scores, stats, and highlights from all of today's games. And check out ABC sideline reporter Jack Arute's column. He's got one on there all on America Online, keyword ABC Sports. When's your column coming out, partner?
It'll be a while. Still working on it. Rick Neuheisel and... Actually, Colorado has not lost to Kansas State since 1984. You got to believe that's a psychological advantage in a game like this, especially if the game comes down to a tight fit situation.
Three receivers set. Hessler going to roll out to the right on first down. Nowhere to throw, but he's run out of bounds by Deshaun Carter after a gain of about four. Carter, the man you talked about that may be picked on today.
Still not bad, though. He picks up 4 yards on the carry, bring up second down and six, come back with a little pass. Got to love Oaks and Kelly and Simino. These guys, they run to the football, though. See how quickly they got over there? There was lost containment by the defensive end, Clements, but the linebackers got over to keep the game just to 4 yards.
Simino and Oaks, the defensive newcomers of the year the last couple of years in the Big 12. Chris Canny had that award the year before, so three straight for the Kansas State defense. Hessler rolling again, gained four on the last one, and this time knocked out of bounds after a gain of about three. Lamar Chapman, who has come back after the elbow injury, ran him out.
Chapman playing safety, now played cornerback last year when Joe Gordon broke his leg. Remember that? That was some backfield they had with Canny and Gordon and yeah. Mario, all those guys back there. That was one of the weaknesses. Everybody had concerns about the secondary coming in to this season, but it's played quite well, although this is the biggest test that the secondary's had yet.
Chapman, a great return man as well in terms of punts. The 95 defense for Kansas State was the number one defense in the country. They think this one is in line with that. A key third down for Colorado. Hessler, under pressure, throws incomplete, and he had a man. He had his tight end Hefner, but there is a flag down in the backfield. So they roughed up John Hessler, Darren Howard, I believe, was in there.
It was Howard. Now watch this. He's coming on the backside, has a clear shot at Hessler. But see if the ball's gone. See if there's a step. See if he could have stopped. Ball's gone. Oh, that's the problem.
Yes.
It doesn't matter whether the ball's gone or not. He went after the head. You can't do it. Flagrant foul. They'll move at 15. That's a personal foul. You can't go for a guy's head and use that hat as a weapon.
And that's huge. The Kansas State defense coming up with a stop on 3rd and 3. But Howard, and he did it. He went right out the head of John Hessler.
I don't know what Bill Snyder's complaining about. That's in the rule book. It's clear. And the replay showed it.
And you're right. It doesn't matter if you're late or not. 8 in the box for Kansas State. Oh, I don't try to run against it. Michelle Troutman can't get outside. And actually, that's Marlon Barnes, number 9, the junior out of Memphis, who's been out with an injury.
We didn't know if he'd play or not. He's got some cartilage problems. They didn't know how his lateral movement would be, but look at this. It looks like he's running on ice. Watch his feet. Now, they pull the guard out in front of him now. He really never got going. Stumbled coming out of the block, stumbled again. Never really got that motor running.
Jeff Kelly with the stop. There's a quick one at linebacker, too, but Barnes has not had his knee scoped, and they can't tell what's exactly wrong with him. Well, he makes the comeback today, but they say he does not make his lateral moves very well at all. He runs straight ahead. Hessler with a lot of room. Breaks outside across midfield. And it's got a first down for the Buffalo. Good decision by Hessler.
You know, every time Colorado can move the chains, every time the offense can get a first down, stay on there, melt some of the clock, it's helping the defense. It's keeping Bishop on the bench. The more that you can keep Bishop on the bench, that's the best defense, and that's the best way to beat Kansas State. You're right about his decision. He waited. He felt the pocket come. He stepped up, and there was absolutely nobody midfield. Went to the outside and got the first.
And the other thing about sitting on the bench a long time today, wind chill's about 15 to 20 degrees.
Yeah, and you mentioned his ankle's not 100%. He got it nicked up a little bit again today. That won't help him.
First down inside the 45. They're going to run off the left side down to close to the 40 goes Barnes once again. But we didn't really think that we would see Marlon Barnes, as you said, and the knee injury against Texas, and was the fastest of all the running backs for Colorado and a straight-ahead tough runner, which they've needed this year. Compliment to Rochelle Troutman.
Well, you know, we talked about Mike Stoops, the defensive coordinator at Kansas State. He's a young, aggressive coach. Players love him. And he really runs some serious defenses at you. His defense is aggressive. They're coming on the blitz.
Directing traffic. Here they come. Barnes wrapped up. Nowhere to go. Jared Cooper, the redshirt freshman out of Parlin, Texas.
Out of a safety blitz, we talked about it just before. You could almost feel it was coming.
Till the end of the first quarter, but all field goals so far, 6-3 Wildcats.
Go, Cats!
See, it says here you're lazy, highly unmotivated. You have a problem with authority.
Yeah, I've got two references that proves that.
Well, the only thing I can say is, you demand! You demand!
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
Technically, I can't give you a raise yet.
You're right, policy, schmalsy.
Traditional luxury cars. The slumber. The serenity. The isolation. Hey, you're not dead yet. Presenting the supercharged Bonneville, one of the world's most powerful sports sedans. Made traditional luxury? Rest in peace. Luxury with attitude. The Bonneville by Pontiac.
National Car Rental presents The Drive for the National Championship. The year 1968. Woody Hayes and number 2 Ohio State host number 4 Michigan in their annual showdown. The Buckeyes were led by an amazing sophomore class that included Jack Tatum, Jim Stillwagon, and quarterback Rex Kern. A dominating 50-14 triumph sent a record Ohio Stadium crowd into a frenzy. The Buckeyes finished 10-0, claiming the 1968 national championship.
As a business traveler, you can choose from thousands of places to stay. But when it comes to renting a car, there's really only one place to go. National Car Rental. Because when you join National's Emerald Club, you can bypass the counter, choose your own car, and get on the road fast. So what are you waiting for? Let's go. National Car Rental.
This is College Football on ABC Sports.
Terry Gannon, Tim Brandt, Lewis Johnson back in a very cold Manhattan, Kansas. 6'3", you're looking at Ben Kelly, the top return man in the nation, and the ice pack on the forehead. Doesn't feel too good at this point with the weather the way it is, but trying to recoup on the sidelines.
Kansas State pressures you, crowds the line of scrimmage, plays man. They're doing that right now on third down.
Third and seven, Hessler, with time, got a man complete at the 30-yard line. And a first down, it's his tight end, Brody Hefner.
Well, we talk about big targets. How about Brody Hefner, 6'5" going against Travis Oakes. They got man coverage, so they go to a quick three-step drop. He's looking to the out pattern for his tight end, and he has him matched up against the linebacker, Oakes. You know, Oakes, he's a glue-type guy who holds things together defensively. He had good coverage. He just couldn't climb the big tight end, 6'5", to get to the football.
And Hefner's been a big target. He had 13 catches coming into this game. So first down, play action. Hessler looking deep over the middle. Plugging up. What a play. Dimitri Denmark got a hand in there at the last instant.
That's pretty good coverage on Stiggers. Stiggers thinks he has him beat. The ball is pretty well thrown, too. But look at Denmark. I mean, he just plays the ball and gets up and knocks it away. Really didn't have a chance for the pick. He's got to extend fully just to knock it away. But that's how close it was. You know, in games like this, you can see guys, you can feel guys that feel like they're hot. I think right now, Phil Savoy thinks he's that guy. Every time he runs a pattern, he's coming back complaining that they didn't throw to him. He wants the football.
And they haven't gotten it to him so far. Hessler really not even looking for him. Savoy, probably the most dangerous man in terms of the wideouts. Well, tonight on ABC, Leslie Nielsen is back in a movie special with Priscilla Presley and Anna Nicole Smith. One of Timmy's favorites, Naked Gun 33 1/3. The final insult at 8 o'clock Eastern, 7 Central, followed by Dylan McDermott in a brand new episode of The Practice tonight on ABC.
While we were talking up here, Savoy went to the sidelines. He was almost begging for the football.
It's Dwayne Cherington now in for Rochelle Troutman, the lone setback. Second and 10. Hessler backs him up. Option to the near side. Looks for a lane. Has one for a moment, but it closes quickly. Jeff Kelly, the middle linebacker with great speed. The JUCO All-American out of LaGrange, Texas.
Jeff Kelly, the leading tackler, 48 tackles for the year, 28 tackles for losses. But look at it, number 8 in the middle of your screen come through untouched and actually trail the play and make the play from behind. Great speed by the middle linebacker. He's got 6 sacks on the year. He's got 20 tackles for losses, making 21.
Kelly with the speed, Oakes with the leadership, Simino a solid outside linebacker. That's a great trio for the Wildcat. Another big third down. Chris Anderson in motion. Hessler under pressure, down he goes. Simino got there and tripped him up. Third sack of the year for Mark Simino, the sophomore out of Smith Center, Kansas.
Watch the bottom right-hand screen right here, and you're going to see Johanningmeyer can't get out quick enough to stop him. Johanningmeyer tries to chop him and can't get there. Great body control by Simino to actually take his feet out as he flies by. Boy, that's an athletic play right there. Guy plays sideline to sideline. He's got tremendous quickness. Plays on the weak side, oftentimes uncontested from the tight end, off the tight end side.
It's been all field goals so far. This one, a 46-yard try by Jeremy Aldridge. Got enough leg just inside the left upright, and it's good.
How about this? Two explosive teams, great offensive teams, and we've got 4 field goals.
Cold weather, maybe having its effect. We're tied at 6. Good one going on in the Big 12.
To you, it looks like this. To a car thief, it looks like this. And to our Ford Motor Company engineers, it looks like one of the most powerful anti-theft devices ever. Only this key sends an electronic code to the engine before it will ever start. So it looks like your new Mercury Sable will be just where you parked it. Ford. Quality is job one.
Michael Jordan is CEO Jordan.
Is a handsaw. And this is Handy. A cordless circular saw. Powered by VersaPak, built by Black & Decker.
Presenting the Valvoline Big Play Rebate and Sweepstakes. Save $4 on a case of Valvoline Motor Oil, and you could win one of six Mark Martin signature Ford Thunderbirds. Here comes Mark now. He's up and right on the money. Valvoline, the number one choice of top mechanics.
Richard Dreyfuss, Elijah Wood in the Charles Dickens classic. Oliver Twist, ABC Sunday at 7, 6 Central.
Special teams telling the story so far here between Colorado and Kansas State. 6-6, four field goals. And Colorado set to kick off with Jason Leslie, the senior out of Palacios, Texas. Gerald Niesman with a 99-yard return a week ago against Kansas, the number two return man in the country. We'll see what he can do. They kicked away from him the last time.
Yeah, and I think they may continue to do that. The only bad thing is you give them pretty good field position when you pooch it high and get one of those sunshine kicks.
And you've got Goolsby, a fullback, two fullbacks. Gangwish as well at the 25. They kick it away this time. And it's with the wind 8 yards deep. And that's the decision. You have the win, you kick it off deep. Niesman can't bring it out.
You know, I can't understand how John Leslie can kick without a shoe. I mean, it is cold here. Makes the ball feel like lead. He has no sock on, and the guy's kicking the football and kicking it down out of the end zone, to the back of the end zone.
You watch him, though. He goes to the sideline. He'll put that sock and shoe on quickly.
I hope so. There he goes.
Already.
Oh, he's not putting his sock on, though. See, he's a man.
Better man than I. I got about 10 layers on up here in the booth. Well, Michael Bishop really hasn't had an opportunity to get things going with a passing game yet.
What a talent he is. Bishop calls himself a cross between Tommy Frazier and John Elway. R.C. Slocum of Texas A&M said he looked like Cordell Stewart.
Play action. Looking deep. The far sideline. Man-to-man coverage. McDonald with the catch. No. He had a step. Couldn't hang on. Damon Wheeler on the coverage.
All right, so he only threw it 60 yards that time. And this guy's got a gun. We got into a little debate, the two of us, yesterday.
He against says, the wind, too.
Yeah, he says he threw it 93 yards. I don't think that's humanly possible. But look how strong his arm is. And not only is he throwing into the wind, but he puts a lot of air under it. I mean, he throws it high to let the receiver run under it.
That's a ball that should have been caught.
Look at him. He thinks so, too. He thinks he's hitting. He's backed up. Like a golfer that hits it right into the flag. I mean, he thought that was right there.
The thing you love about him, too, is he thinks he can do anything on a football field. And does oftentimes. Going to throw again. He's going to roll the time.
Man wide open. McDonald has to wait on it. And brought down at the 30.
There's a flag down at the 13-yard line, though. We'll wait and see.
Somebody took a late shot at Bishop. So it's going to be declined, and they'll move it all the way down to the 30. But you have to wonder how he got so wide open. Ryan Sutter, the safety, lets him run by. He's actually looking for the tight end. If you stop it right there, you'll see this is the guy he's looking for, but he is covered. So he'll pull back. And now look, he's wide open, and Sutter, 36, is now chasing.
This time he doesn't overthrow him. He just lets him wait for it. And that's the only shot that Colorado had, is if he had to wait, because here comes Sutter, 36, from behind. But I mean, McDonald got all the way back there. Now here's the hit on Bishop. And that was really late.
Vili Maumau hit him late, and they'll tack it on. So it brings it after the 50-yard pass to McDonald, who gets a breather on the sideline. It's spotted just outside the 15-yard line. First and 10. Hickson wrapped up, and he'll lose about three on the play. Southward, the outside linebacker making the hit.
Ron Merkerson back on the sideline. Southward in for him. Southward read the play from the get-go and got there actually before the ball carrier could. I mean, he was right there to make that hit.
Brandon Southward, the junior out of Colorado Springs, bit of a free spirit.
Yeah, and they do put him on the tight end. You know, he is the tight end watcher. And if the tight end is blocking down, he knows the ball's coming his way.
So Bishop sets up in the shotgun now. Takes the inside grab. He's got some moves. One down to the 12-yard line. And that's a pretty good tackle, actually. You get stuck one-on-one with Bishop on the corner, Timmy.
Tackle by number one.
It's not good news.
Kelly.
Yeah. Kelly and Black, number one and number six, will make the tackle on him. But Bishop, look at this. What a great fake. Boy, look at the fake. Olsen, 55, took that. And now he's out here on the secondary. First, Kelly undercuts him, and Black finishes them off. But tremendous ball handling by the magician, Bishop.
And Kelly was banged up on the last series, too. Right outside his eyes. He got a bump, had the ice on it, but he's back in there and playing. They're coming on the blitz, the pitch to Hickson. Can he turn the corner and get there? He's got a first down.
Ball carries number 24,
the 5-yard line, but he's knocked out there.
Actually, the mark puts it pretty close to where the chains are, but I do think he has it. That is a first. So it'll be first down and goal just inside the five. But again, look at this. They run the option. They get good blocking on the corner. And there's your safety, Black, number six, who gets cut off but gets there in time to knock him out.
Kansas State, 4-yard line.
Boy, they're great play calling right now. Mixing things up. Bishop becoming very effective.
And you've got first and goal inside the five.
See, you a little confused right now.
Goolsby and Hickson in the backfield. Goolsby the fullback in motion. Hickson follows, fights his way down to the three. And he was just stuck there. Ryan Black, a strong safety, made the tackle. Really great stories, too, these two safeties. Ryan Black, Ryan Sutter, two former walk-ons, tough kids who really fought their way into the starting lineup, and now they're really stars for this defense.
Yeah, both of them. You know, we were talking with Ryan Sutter's parents last night at the hotel. Former walk-on, became a special teams ace, scholarship player now, one of CU's top tacklers. He had knee surgery early in the season, fought through that. I mean, it's just a great story.
His mother wanted us to tell him to cut his hair. Hickson looking to get to the end zone. He got there. Touchdown, Kansas State. The first one of the day. The left side, he went right behind that big offensive line.
Jay Cox, Martin, and Young. And it's Martin, 78, that gets off the pile last. Look at him, the purple jersey just moving him out of there. Great blocking, Hickson with the leg strength at the one to get through. And I'm telling you, we talked about the offensive line. They call themselves the tank, and they just rolled it in.
Hickson's ninth touchdown overall. He's got eight rushing touchdowns this year. Hooks it in just inside the left upright.
First touchdown of the game. We'll see now if CU can answer, but Hickson running hard, running quick, and running for six.
Trailers for sale or rent. Rooms to let 50 cents. Mama, man of means, by no king of the road. 2 hours of pushing broom buys an 8-12 four-bedroom. I'm a man of means, by no means king of the road.
This is the Triton-powered Ford F-150, and this is a 102,000-pound earth mover.
Now that's what we call taking the bulldozer by the horns. Ford F-Series, built Ford tough.
They were really growing up fast, too fast. All Kelly talked about was going to high school, and all I could think about was paying for college. Sure, I played around with a few mutual funds, but I was no expert. So I started talking to someone who could help, a broker at Dean Witter.
We must plan for our clients' future as if it were our own.
Funny, kids think their parents always have the right answers. I'm just making sure I do.
We measure success one investor at a time.
ABC Sports presentation of college football brought to you by Ford and your Ford dealer. Have you driven a Ford lately? Chili's Grill and Bar, home of the Big Mouth Burgers. Valvoline, the number one choice of America's top mechanics. People who know use Valvoline. And MetLife. Get met. It pays.
Michael Bishop has just taken Kansas State 80 yards for the first touchdown of the day.
Of course, the big play was to Darnell McDonald. He was looking for his tight end, reloads, buys some time. Now all of a sudden he sees McDonald has gotten behind the safety, Sutter, wide open. Underthrows him a little bit just to make sure that he does have the completion. That allows Sutter to close in, but still they go down and score off that.
So Jamie Ream with a short kick this time. And it's bobbled by Kelly, and the Wildcats have it at the 23. Jared Cooper, the defensive back with the recovery. The wind blowing against the kickoff team, and it blew away from Kelly.
Watch, he stumbles. See that? He stumbles just before he gets there, and it short hops him and hits him right in the shin. Great coverage to come down and get the fumble. But Kelly, who already has a scratched up face, and he's thinking about that a little bit, not totally on the football, then stumbles and fumbles.
And let's get a report from Lewis Johnson on Ben Kelly right now. Lewis?
Guys, he's been in a lot of pain down here on the sideline. Imagine being so cold and having an ice bag on your face. That's because his helmet came loose, hit him in the eye, and he's having a lot of trouble. The eye is swollen like he's been in a boxing match.
All right, Lewis, certainly could have affected him on that return. There goes Bishop. The 10 down to the 6. Michael Bishop on the run. A gain of 17.
One thing you don't want to do is shorten the field with Kansas State. You do that and all of a sudden, here they go now. They start to roll. But watch this. Great speed to get outside. This is a predetermined quarterback draw, and he sees linemen, and he just kind of smiles. He knows he can run around the linemen. But what happens to Navies? Hannibal Navies, the linebackers, is not there. The linebacker has to get there and make that play. They've got to be looking for him because they run that play 12 to 14 times a game.
So it's first and goal at the 6. Lawrence looking to get outside, can't get there. Wrapped up at the 5, and there is a flag inside the 5.
I believe they're going to call this on Grosstead here for holding.
So that will back up Bill Snyder's offense.
Grosstead got into the secondary and just locked on, started dancing with him.
Now, Timmy, special teams with the field goals today and the kickoffs already playing a huge part in terms of field position.
On the offense, 10-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
But with Michael Bishop, this Kansas State offense can explode.
Watch 82 Grosstead. See how he locked on? See how his hands have the jersey right there on Wheeler? Just locked on to him. Actually, tearing his jersey off his shoulder pads.
That one was a bit obvious.
Yeah. And right in front of the side judge.
Bishop with the 50-yard pass to McDonald for the first touchdown moments ago. And then Kelly couldn't get a handle on the kickoff. So Kansas State knocking at the door once again. It's first and goal now back at the 50.
Not a bad thing to come in with your nickel package and put a spy on Bishop.
There goes Bishop looking to run. Got three white jerseys all around him. Reverses his field. Wrapped up and pounded by Mau Mau at the 33.
You know, Mau Mau missed him once, came back and got him.
And maybe
too much running by Bishop that time.
Well, they did come in with their nickel package, but what they did is they had great containment on both sides. See, he doesn't have any outside leverage and figures, all right, I got to go back. All right, there's the miss by Mau Mau, 77. But watch him now. He gets up off the ground, and for a big guy, whoo, here he comes. Mau Mau's 295 pounds. Missed him, got off the ground, came up, and hit him again.
You dream of those opportunities. You're a defensive lineman.
There's a guy that squats 720 pounds.
All the way back outside the 30 now. Over the middle to Schmidt, the tight end, breaks away. Touchdown, Kansas State. 32-yard strike from Bishop to Justin Swift.
Pass was complete for Michael Bishop to number 86, Justin Swift.
You know, Ryan Sutter, the free safety, was playing center field, saw this ball, opted not to take the interception, but instead hit him at the time of the catch. There's the hit, but he just falls off, doesn't wrap his arms, and there's a touchdown by Swift. Bad decision by Ryan Sutter. If you're going to hit a guy to try to knock him loose rather than try to get the pick, you better make sure you knock it loose, and if you don't, wrap your arms and take him down.
Sutter goes about 205, Justin Swift over 250. I'll take that matchup if I'm Swift. Ramatica with the extra point. And the Kansas State offense exploding. They got the help and the fumble on the kickoff, so they put it right to the end zone. Bishop to Swift. Ouch.
You don't need binoculars to see why Escort is so popular. It's a value so enticing, it's like getting cake with extra icing. You can get power, lots of power, power galore, to whisk down the windows and unlock the doors, adjust the side mirrors, but wait, there is more. Opt for a remote, AC, a smooth automatic, and a CD player for the music fanatic. And if that's not enough, you can get an anti-theft system to protect this good stuff. The buck starts here for Escort thrills, somewhat higher, loaded to the gills.
Hi, I'm John Buechner, president of the University of Colorado. At CU, learning takes place inside the mind and outside the classroom, mentoring neighborhood school children, taking the first steps toward the global scientific community, meeting the needs of an evolving workplace. Whether you're scaling a mountain by degrees or pursuing your own degree, meet your challenge at the University of Colorado, a total learning environment.
Impact. It can be as subtle as a new thought, or it can be dramatic, like meeting a challenge that will touch many lives. Whether it's innovative research, harnessing the technology of the future, or simply learning a little bit more about yourself and your world, our students are prepared to make an impact on tomorrow. Changing the world, one mind at a time. That's Kansas State University.
Promotional consideration provided by National Car Rental, the official car rental company of ABC Sports.
Look at Ryan Sutter with his helmet on. He's the safety. Missed the tackle, and Kansas State scored to make it 26. Here he is right here. Go ahead and roll it, and I'll show you. He saw this play develop, and he actually makes a pretty good play. He's an outstanding safety, but watch. You either have to commit yourself to the interception. Stop it right here. All right. You have to commit yourself to the interception or dislodging it and wrapping your arms. Go ahead and roll it. You'll see he goes to dislodge it but doesn't wrap his arms. Instead, Swift makes the catch, bounces off of him, and scores.
Mrs. Sutter is not going to want to watch that replay.
Well, even Ryan is upset with himself. He's an outstanding safety. He knows he made a bad play.
Kelly bobbled the last one. This a short kick that goes out of bounds against the wind, but they'll bring it out to the 35-yard line. That barely made the 30. Bill Snyder wanted a pooch kick, but he didn't want to kick it out of bounds.
Illegal procedure, kick out of bounds. The ball will be put in play at the 35.
Well, a lot of football left right here in Manhattan, but some good football tonight on ESPN2. Number 5, Tennessee. SEC championship still on the line. Alliance Bowl, everything else. Peyton Manning entering his final stretch of his senior year. That's tonight at 8 o'clock Eastern, 7 Central on ESPN2. The Vols still very much in the hunt. snaps on first down. Hessler running the option. Keeps it, still up, now knocked down at the 42-yard line. Good carry on first down for Hessler. John Saunders, what's going on?
Well, Terry, it is a wild one out west. UCLA and Washington both needing to win to get to the Rose Bowl. Cade McNown, 47 yards over the top to Jim McElroy. This one tied it at 14 apiece. Washington has just come back and scored another one. Brock Huard, 20-14 now. The point after is pending. Terry.
You've got Washington, Washington State next week. You've got UCLA, USC next week. Good action on the Pac-10. Still a lot the Rose Bowl story to be told. Dwayne Charrington straight ahead, tough running, and he's got a first down for the Buffaloes.
Talk about UCLA. What a job Bob Toledo has done there this year after losing the first couple and then being on the hot seat. I mean, they've just gone on a tear. He's changed the entire thing. It's a tough football team now. Had them going 1-on-1 in the locker room before coming out and playing. They're Washington. I mean, that's unbelievable.
That was the criticism, that they were a soft football team. It has been the last couple of years, but it's a different club right now. Beat by Washington State, though, early on. That's one that may haunt them. First down for Colorado. Charrington with a wide open, breaks through. One man to beat. It's Chapman. The break to the outside. Knocked out inside the 5-yard line at the 1 is Dwayne Charrington.
That's 3 runs in a row for Colorado. Very unusual for a team that throws 30 times. Obviously, they see something that they are attacking. All right, now this is something they felt like they could do. Look at the hole he gets, though. He gets a great push from all those white jerseys. They dominate the line of scrimmage. Now here's your safety, Chapman, going to try to chase him down now. Knocks him out at the 1 and saves the touchdown. Actually, his foot hit the line. That's a great play of 51 yards. And CU just bounces right back with the running game.
Well, they've given up big plays defensively, but offensively, look at what they have done the last 5 games.
Plays over 20 yards and keeping the ball game every time.
They're in fixed, the fullback. Marlon Barnes. Bottles, loose. Kansas State has it. Chapman at the 17-yard line with the recovery.
Are you kidding me?
That has been the story this year for John Hessler in Colorado.
Well, Howard came with the pressure and screwed things up. Then they started stumbling around. The ball went loose. But how about Chapman? Chapman's extra effort knocked him out and saved the touchdown. Now he recovers this. Look, here comes the pressure. Hessler stumbles. He never gets the ball because it hits his chest plate, high on his number. Now watch. Here's Chapman. The ball bounces right up to him. So all that extra effort to save the touchdown, chasing him down and knocking him out, pays big benefits, and he comes back and gets the fumble recovery. That ball just hit him high on the chest plate. Barnes just never got it. Hessler came out of there stumbling because of the pressure coming down from the defensive end, Howard.
All too familiar scene for Rick Neuheisel and the Buffs this year. And Lawrence, good gain on first down to the 27. And a subdued, maybe shocked sideline right now. Running it all the way down to the 1-yard line at first and goal. And Hessler left shaking his head.
Yeah, look, John's talking to himself. Can't believe it. I mean, you would think that's a sure touchdown, and all of a sudden, the ball game's close again.
A gain of 9 after the running play. There goes Lawrence. He's got a first down up to the 34, maybe the 35-yard line.
You know, it looks right now like CU's defense is so conscious of the run by Bishop and the pass game that they're starting to play soft. They're catching. They're not being as aggressive as they normally are. Watch the purple jerseys lock on, and then watch. White jerseys are just being backed out of there. It's almost like they're catching blocks rather than defeating them to get to the ball carrier.
They've spent a lot of time on the field.
A.J. Kristoff, defensive coordinator.
Lawrence looks for room, bounces away from 1, but wrapped up behind the line of scrimmage.
That'll help. That'll put him in second down and long.
Brady McDonald was in on that. Ryan Black as well. Now, this defensive front for Colorado, too. Rick Neuheisel and A.J. Kristoff really challenged him last week before the Iowa State game. They gave up a lot of points, but they made some big plays, especially up front. Vili Maumau, one of them. Terrell Kay, the defensive end, and they felt better about this front. But now they spent a lot of time on the field here in the first half. Bishop play action. Throws complete. Perez with a catch, first down.
Pass was complete.
Damon Wheeler ran him out of bounds.
To number 87.
I've got to tell you something. Mike Phillips is the nickel linebacker. They had him in. They were in a nickel situation. He came backside on the blitz, but was tentative. He's so aware of the versatility and escapability of Bishop. Watch, he'll stop almost. Look, he stops and waited for the blocker before he made contact. Then the ball's just thrown perfectly. You know, you say what you will about this guy. He's got a strong arm, and he's a great runner, but he also now becoming a very accurate passer.
Kevin Parise, too, played very well over the last three or four games. Bishop keeps it. Ball's ahead for a gain of about two. Timmy, you look at this drive right now as Ty Gregorek, the freshman, made the tackle. This is a key defensive series for Colorado. You've got 438 and counting. They've given up 20 points in the first half, some on special teams, but they've got to stop them here.
Yeah, I felt that way in the last drive, to be honest with you, but this one now really brings a sense of urgency. Colorado's defense has had only one really bad game. That was Missouri. But they do give up big plays, and it's killed them here in this first half.
Play action. Bishop with time again. Goes behind his tight end, Justin Swift, and he was open.
Let's say this. Every time Bishop throws, he's being knocked down. And eventually, that's going to take its toll. He's going to start looking to see where they're coming from, and he's going to throw out of rhythm. He's not going to set and wait like he has been.
He's only completed four passes, but he's got 124 yards and a touchdown. Big strike, a 50-yarder to McDonald.
Well, for the season, he's only in the low 40% range. He's getting better. But the thing is, when he connects, it's usually a big play.
Big hole this time for Lawrence, straight ahead, but it closed once he got through that initial front. Down to the 47, Ty Gregorek, the true freshman, tripped him up.
Here comes your critical third down situation. Or fourth down. You're in their territory. You would think, all right, you're up 20-6. Do you take this fourth and try to get the first when you need four or five? They say no, they're going to punt it.
Rochell Troutman back deep at his own 10-yard line. James Garcia under pressure. They went after him a little bit. It hits Derek Cooper right in the helmet. Down inside the one. Now it touched Cooper all the way back out. That's where it's got to be spotted.
Yeah, they've got it spotted right now at the 23, but I think he hit it up by about the 25 or 26.
Hit him right in the head.
It was only as far as he could throw his beanbag.
At this spot.
See what yard line that hit him on the head.
Well, they're not sure where they're going to spot it now. It looks maybe like it's a 23.
Well, they're spotting it where the beanbag landed. All right, now they move it up to the 25. Here it is again. See where it hits his helmet. It's a short punt. Nobody's looking for it. Nobody's calling ball. All right, so that's pretty good accurate. Marking to put it right there at the 25-yard line.
Yeah, that really helped Colorado, the fact that it hit him in the head. Otherwise, it's probably inside the 10. It's only a 23-yard punt, though. The whistle of dead.
They were pretty accurate with that beanbag. He threw it about 30 yards. All right, Hessler's got 3:28 to work. He's got to use the sidelines, got to get him in and out of the huddle with urgency and be accurate.
Three receivers set, penalty markers down. Hessler hit as he throws. Got a man one-on-one. Incomplete. Marcus Stickers was out there. Denmark on the coverage, but Andre Rowe put a lick on John Hessler. And we'll see what the marker is all about.
On the offense. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
And another penalty, the false start, which has been one of the problems for Colorado this year.
Good news, bad news. Hey, you get that play over, but they're going to move you back 5 yards. And time now is down to 3:21. Watch what happens after Hessler releases his football, though. He gets pretty good coverage. He feels like, all right, I can step up and throw, and he does. And all of a sudden, then just takes it to the chops. Well, Olsen came hard, too.
You mentioned it earlier, and he still hasn't done it. He hasn't looked towards Phil Savoy at all.
You know, and Savoy was begging early. He's not even doing that anymore.
He wanted the football, felt like he could go ahead and make something happen. Here he's locked onto the freshman, 35. That's your freshman cornerback. Phil Savoy is 6'3". He's a senior. He's an outstanding receiver. And right now he's matched up against Carter, who's only 5'9 and a half, and he's a freshman.
There's your referee, Hal Dowden, making a phone call. Maybe a problem with the clock. Right now it shows 3:28. And they may have to put some seconds back on.
Well, they did.
Yeah, they put eight seconds back on. It was at 3:20. So now we're set. They've gotten it right. First and 15 after the false start. Esler looks, runs, dives out to the 22. Jeff Kelly made sure he stayed down. And Phil Savoy was locked up again, and they didn't even look towards
him. Yeah, and here's the deal now. Carter, the freshman's the one that's starting to feel confident and cocky. He's going up and patting Savoy on the butt, you know, and talking to him a little bit. He's got a little bit of Chris Carter in him. He's very, very instinctive.
Redshirt freshman out of Denver.
Yeah, he's the guy that was in that serious bus accident this past summer. Best friend died in it. He was banged up very badly.
Hooked up with Kohler this time. Can you see the set again? Throws, and that's who the intended receiver was, but Hessler overthrows Robert Toler, who is one-on-one with Carter.
Colorado really out of sync right now, and they're still not looking to fill Savoy. I know we've got a pretty good view up here, but I want you to watch. Here he is at very top of your screen. Savoy comes underneath, and look at it. He is wide open, and they're not even looking at it.
And Cheverini's even pointing towards him.
Play was set up perfectly, and they never looked as well.
Savoy to the far side. Anderson in the slot. Marcus Stiggers to the near side.
See if they come back with that same play.
In the air. Picked off at the 28. After the deflection, Joe Bob Clemens, the junior out of Emporia, Kansas, comes up with the pick.
Boy, what a great push up the middle by the defense. Watch this. Hessler, he's got to find the lane to throw, and he doesn't, but Evans gets up and gets a big paw on it. Now look, all purple jerseys. You get a couple whites over there. Anderson came in low, but Clemens comes in. You got to get it at its highest point. And look at Clemens, number 46, go up and get that ball, using his body to shield people off. Play was made by Evans to knock it loose, but then when everybody went for it, it was Clemens that came up with the INT.
So a great opportunity for the offense now for Kansas State, though, after their pick. They run it with Lawrence going off the right side, gain of about four. But, Timmy, the special teams and now mistakes. The pick, the fumble down at the one-yard line. Mistakes again hurting Colorado.
And with all the talent on Colorado, it looks as if when things start to go bad, they lose confidence a little bit and get very tentative.
31% off the turnover. Play action, Bishop to the near side. Getting a block. Breaks it outside, tackled maybe late. We'll see if there's a flag, none yet.
Should be.
He's got the first down though. Bishop. Big old Todd Weiner, number 75, led the way.
Good play action. But you know, this is the guy you have to be watching. Forget the play action. You've got to be watching Bishop at all times. And then see the contact's made well within the playing field. There is absolutely nothing illegal about that. Good no call. Boy, you look at the guys making blocks downfield. That's Wade, 75. He's a 300-pounder.
Going to run it back to the far side. This time is Bishop. Took some punishment, too, on the tackle. Sutter was in there.
You know, we talk about how big this offensive line is, but they're downfield making blocks 10, 15 yards downfield. Got great feet. They run so well, you have to believe these guys are going to play on the next level. And it's survival of the fittest on that offensive line. Guys have been getting banged up, and yet they continue to make big plays.
6'4", 316 pounds on average. Bishop with a world of time. Got McDonald after the bobble. First down, down to the five, and Kelly wraps him up.
Pass was complete from Michael Bishop to number 80, Darnell McDonald
caught a 50-yarder earlier in the second quarter. They go to him again, and they've got first and goal.
Yeah, and another missed tackle. I don't know if you saw Wheeler come over and miss a tackle, gave him another 5 yards.
Wildcat.
Colorado has to start wrapping up defensively. They're beating themselves.
First down and goal, Kansas State, 5-yard line.
And if you're A.J. Kristoff or Rick Neuheisel, you say, we're in position. We're in position to make plays. We're just not making them. This time they do. Bishop inside the 5 to the 4. Ryan Black got there with some help.
Rick Neuheisel couldn't get anybody's attention on the field. He sent Ben Kelly all the way down to the side judge to call timeout. Now he walks back up near Neuheisel.
And Kansas State calls the timeout while we have a moment. Let's check in to see what is coming up at halftime.
Coming up on Valvoline Halftime 97, games with the Rose Bowl hanging in the balance. We'll have the highlights.
And we'll also talk about some of the crazy going-ons in the polls here the last couple weeks.
It's all coming up on Valvoline Halftime 97.
John and Todd will have all the action in a few moments, 53 seconds of game time left until the half here in Manhattan.
Those guys in New York talking about what a mix-up it has been in the polls after Judgment Day. How about the bowl situation with so many teams on the bubble, so many teams still alive? Here, of course, Colorado fighting to get in and to even qualify for a bowl. They've got to win either today or against Nebraska next week.
They're at home against Nebraska, but you got to figure you'd want to win today.
Yeah, so you would think there'd be a tremendous sense of urgency. And, of course, for the Wildcats, they want an Alliance Bowl situation. They want to finish up 10-1. Their only loss being to Nebraska.
They're number 8 right now. You look at the top 6, really, and you've got, of course, next week, Ohio State and Michigan playing, number 2 against number 4. Florida State still has to play Florida. A lot of football left, and nothing is sealed by any means right now.
Now, I would think the most likely destination right now for K-State is the Cotton Bowl, but they still want that alliance, and they're still alive for it.
Gangwish and Goolsby, two fullbacks. Goolsby fighting his way, powering his way to the end zone. The second effort by Brian Goolsby, the junior out of Dodge City, Kansas, a 4-yard run to pay dirt.
You could say, I'm coming right at you. He could tell him where he was going to run. It didn't matter. He ran right over him. 250-pounder. Watch him. He's going to line up. Here comes your linebacker, Phillips, 91. He gets blocked out. There's the hole. There's Mau Mau. He can't get him. Now he's in against Sutter. Sutter can't make the tackle. Goolsby runs right over him and into the end zone. You talk about a power back. There he is. They say he's down 15 pounds from a year ago. He's still a load.
15 pounds from 265 is still big. Dramatica on for the extra points. Flicks the upright.
Extra point is good.
For the Wildcats on a roll. They've taken advantage of the mistakes that the Buffaloes have made. And this is a big lead here in the first half.
This is a great run. He gets great contact. He is actually stopped. And then watch his second effort. First, there's the hole. Then he's in the secondary. There's the contact. Now watch this. Bounces off that. Keeps his legs going. That is a great run by a power back.
Second touchdown of the year. So Rick Neuheisel, who has experienced a very disappointing season, to say the least. They came in with great expectations. They were picked anywhere from number 1 to number 12 or 13 in the country.
Yeah, but I think when the Sporting News picked him number 1, there were a lot of people that looked at that and said, you know, they aren't as good as what the Sporting News thinks. And I think Rick was one of those guys. He expected to be better than they are, but I don't think that he really believed and bought into this, that they were number 1. So a lot of pressure was put on him by the media. And then, of course, the local media jumped on him even harder. Hessler started playing a little inconsistent. Things started to fall apart. They got shell-shocked early on.
And they really had a lot of injuries, especially on defense,
yeah,
too. That's
I agree.
Definitely hurt them. Not to make excuses, but certainly has played a role. Now 14 Kansas State points off of 3 Colorado turnovers. Jamie Ream kicking it to Ben Kelly. Fumbled one earlier, and he's taken down by the man who recovered that fumble. Jared Cooper with the hit. And I mean him.
Tough to
to stop a runaway roller coaster. I mean, right now, watch number 40 come bouncing into the right hand of your screen. Whoop! These guys are playing with emotion. They're flying around. They're wild-eyed. They're having fun. Look at that. This big smile on his face.
You know, the Home Depot Coaches Fact deals with Bill Snyder, the only Kansas State coach to have a career record over 500 since Teddy Roosevelt was in office. Alaska and Hawaii were not states. Joseph Stalin leading the USSR. Hessler on the run. Got a first down, runs out of bounds.
Good play. Good clock management. Got the first. Run out of bounds. 37 and a half seconds left. See if you can get down and at least get a field goal out of this.
Well, and with all the problems this season for this offense and for John Hessler, the one thing that they have been able to do is they have come back in games time and again, early on especially, but last week against Iowa State, they were down by 18 twice and came back a long drive to win it at the end of the game. Receiver set. Quick drop. Stiggers. A little bit low.
Stops the clock 34.3. Remember, they've got a couple timeouts. They don't want to take those into the locker room with them. Still have not looked for Savoy.
Second down 10, 38-yard line.
If he makes that catch, it's a gain of maybe four. That's about it. So the fact that he didn't make it certainly doesn't hurt at all.
Now, if you're going to go across the middle, if you're going to put a guy in the middle of the field, better be ready to call a timeout.
Only 3 of 11 for Hessler. And he hasn't gone to Savoy yet. This one batted down. Could have been picked off again. And again, it was 6'6", Jerome Evans with a big hand in the air.
He's having fun. The guys in purple jerseys right now are having fun. I mean, they have all the momentum. Obviously, they've got the lead 27-6. It's easy to have fun that way. But, I mean, it's tough to stop a team when they're like that. They're in that mode. They're in that positive, consistent, cocky mode.
Making big plays. A little less than 30 seconds. 29.5 and counting. They're going to run it this time. Wayne Charrington, did he get the first down? I don't believe so. Just shy of the marker, at least. And we will see.
Colorado took a lot of time before they called the timeout. 19 seconds to go.
So it would bring up, Timmy, fourth and one with 19 seconds. And while we have a moment, let's take a look at what is coming up on ABC.
Tonight at 8, 7 Central, the gang from Naked Gun is back.
I'm wearing the nightgown you bought me for our honeymoon.
Frank Drebin's his name, and Danger's his game. Leslie Nielsen, Priscilla Presley, and Anna Nicole Smith.
What are you doing in my bathing suit?
Naked Gun, 33 and a third. ABC tonight at 8, 7 Central.
The Buffalo Bills, the Miami Dolphins. Old rivals meet with a division lead on the line on Monday Night Football.
Bring on the game now!
Can you ever look at Leslie Nielsen and not laugh, no matter what he's doing?
You know, I'm trying to figure out this timeout. I'm not sure why Colorado called it with 19 seconds left. You'd think they let the clock roll. I mean, they're just kicking the ball away here. You're going to give Kansas State more time.
You're right. If you're going to go for it on fourth down, then it's one thing, but running away. Nobody back deep for Kansas State. Beaches punt rolling out of bounds inside the 10, and there is 11 seconds left on the clock. A 44-yard punt. So Rick Neuheisel just trying to get to the house right now. Go in, get warm, talk things over, and try to regroup. Neither of those gentlemen will bear a smile on their faces anytime soon.
Got a few snow flurries starting to fall.
Where? In Wyoming? How did you pick that up? I don't see one.
A couple just came to the booth.
Kansas State going to go to one knee and let the clock run out. Mike
Michael Bishop get the crowd on their feet. John Hessler just wants to get warm for a few minutes and figure out a way to move the football in the second half.
Pretty impressive first half by Kansas State, I'll tell you that.
Took advantage of the turnovers and put number on the board. 27 points on the board. And Kansas State with a... The fans in Manhattan throwing tortillas. They want to go to the Fiesta Bowl, and Kansas State could be on their way to an Alliance Bowl. Terry Gannon, Tim Brandt, and Timmy in the first half. It was all Kansas State, and much of it off the mistakes and turnovers of Colorado.
I don't think there's any question about that. Colorado helped him tremendously. Three big turnovers. How about this one right here? Kelly trips, stumbles, the ball hits his shin. They get it. Cooper recovers. Down close, down by the one. They're ready to come back. Barnes can't get the ball. Boom, there he is. There's a turnover. Chapman gets it. Now they go down one more time. Look, it's deflected. Evans got a hand on it. Cooper makes the interception. Clements rather makes the interception. Three turnovers. And at the same time, Hessler's unable to do anything offensively. Just 3 of 12 with an interception. Turned a couple of those into points, and that's been the difference.
And he has yet to go to one of his favorite receivers, Phil Savoy. And he missed last week with a shoulder injury, but Hessler hasn't even looked for him yet this week. Jamie Rehm gets us underway, and this one's going to sail out of the end zone. Ben Kelly without a chance to return it. The number one return man did something on the first one, but not since. And look at the first half possessions.
Well, the first drive Colorado had right here to start the ball game was outstanding. They went down, they got points out of it. Almost had a touchdown, they didn't. They settled for the field goal. Then they go punt, punt, field goal, still in it. All right, now everything starts to change. Fumble, interception, and a punt. And all of a sudden, it's 27-6. Hessler's unable to move the ball because he has not been able to hit his receivers. And Savoy, who's been on the field all day, hadn't gotten one yet.
Back out, first and 10 from the 20-yard line. Rochelle Troutman on the carry over the left side, wrapped up at the line of scrimmage. He hasn't been able to do a whole lot so far here in Manhattan. And the Dean Witter first half statistics, here they are. They tell the story, especially the turnovers.
Yeah, exactly. That's why we highlighted them, the three turnovers we just talked about, and look at the points off of 14 points. Everything else has been fairly even except the passing yards. That's because Michael Bishop has just been outstanding all day, running and passing.
Well, it's second and 9. Straight drop under pressure from McIntyre. Hessler gets away and then dives down at the 26-yard line. Well, they are not letting John Hessler breathe this afternoon. It's that Kansas State defense, especially the pass defense, that has been so good the last couple of years.
You know, Hessler has taken all the heat this year. Not all of it deserved. I mean, the offensive line just letting guys run free. I mean, you can see right there how the guys just came through. McIntosh, 77, broke through. The Oaks just waiting to make the tackle. I mean, there is not a whole lot of room for Hessler to move.
Evans, McIntosh, Clements, and Howard up front. Doing a terrific job for the Wildcats. Well, it's third and 4. Hessler wanted to change the play, but he doesn't have enough time. Which brings the crowd out of their seats once again. The timeout called. He'll have a word with Rick Neuheisel, and it's not a happy one. Timeout on the field. We will take a break, step away, and be back as well.
The new Dodge Durango is like no sport utility you've ever seen. Say, for instance, you live in a neighborhood with a rhino problem. In a Durango, you could outrun him with the most powerful engine offered in the class. Or you could move him with its best-in-class towing capacity. Or if push really came to shove, Durango's superior horn would prevail. Durango, new ground for the new Dodge.
I want my baby back, baby back, baby back, baby back, baby back, baby back, baby back. I want my baby back.
Chili's baby back rib.
I want my baby back.
Chili's baby back rib.
Barbecue sauce.
I want my baby back.
Chili's baby back rib.
I want my baby.
Chili's baby back rib.
Barbecue sauce.
I got my baby back.
Chili's grills like no place else.
My name is Frank Maddox. I'm a baseball scout for the Seattle Mariners.
244 pounds, he probably is a little hefty. We need somebody else for center field.
But there's no way I'm going to Phoenix, man. It's too hot. You gotta try looking in the future, and that's a tough thing to do.
The gang from Naked Gun is back tonight at 8, 7 Central, and they're hot.
What are you doing in my bathing suit?
Naked Gun, 33 and a third. ABC tonight, 8, 7 Central.
Phil Savoy came into the game with 29 catches. He still has 29 catches.
Well, you know, a shoulder injury kept him out last week, and he may have gotten out of the way of Hessler. I mean, Hessler's not looking for him at all today, maybe because he wasn't there last week, but he's been open a lot. They aren't even looking at his number. He has no catches, as you said. That's got to be frustrating.
Number four receiver in Colorado history. Hessler, the option, the pitch back, fighting for a first down. We'll see where they mark it. It looks like they got a good spot.
That's a great second effort, too, after the first contact. Maybe we'll see a better resolve out of Colorado. It looked like they got the wind taken out of them early. Those three turnovers, they just seemed to play tentatively there in the last 8 minutes of the first half.
And they haven't really been able to establish the running game at all. Hershel Troutman, 18 yards in the game. That's all. Wayne Charrington, the sophomore, comes in for a down. Number 10 gets the call. Fights his way, spins, and is brought down by Lamar Chapman.
You know, actually, I'm not sure I agree with that statement, Terry. I think they outrushed Kansas State in the first half. They got the running game going pretty well. They just couldn't complement it with any passing.
Well, it was going early in the first drive of the football game. You're right, after the long return by Ben Kelly. But after that, little bits and pieces, but the turnovers, and it, you've got Hessler now also putting the ball on the ground.
You're absolutely right. The turnovers, therein lies the key. They had 133 yards rushing the first half, but three turnovers, you're right.
And he's done that on the option throughout the year. Ill-advised pitches on the quarterback. Charrington, tough running. Look at his way for a first down. And maybe a spark for this Colorado offense.
Well,
second effort.
You have to like that. I don't care. Look at that. I mean, he just put his head down. He's an excellent guy at reading defenses. There was no reading to do. He just found a window, finally goes head on to a guy, and then pushes him back. Watch this now. There's the opening. Gets over that tackler. Now, there he is. Chapman, one-on-one, and just bulls his way down for the first down. You have to like that.
95 yards in the game. One guy who's been able to really run. Not this time, though. He's going to lose a couple. Travis Oakes, number 50. In the backfield.
You know, Charrington had over 3,400 career yards in high school, 15 touchdowns his senior year. He was a sleeper as a recruit. The guy can run the football. Coaches really like the way he plays and they like the fire that he puts in the offense. They need somebody like that right now to juice them.
Had a big game a week ago, too, and a comeback win over Iowa State. Couple of touchdowns, the game winner with 9 seconds left. Second and 12. Here comes the blitz again. Kelly, he missed him. Hessler had Cheverini open, but he couldn't hit him. He did, though, avoid the rush.
Hessler's frustrated with himself. He stepped up past the rush and then rushed the throw and bounced it out there. Once he got past the rush, watch this, all right? He sets, he feels the blitz, here comes Oak, here comes the safety. Now, he steps up past that. Now there's no reason to rush. He could go ahead and push off his back foot and get a good throw, but he didn't. And look, he turned and went, oh! Bounced it out there, short hopping it.
For the sack, and Hessler had plenty of time, and then it just collapsed around him.
Yeah, old Melvin Thomas is out there shaking his head. He's the right guard. He stuck with him for a little while. Watch number 78 back up in a white jersey. See him coming over? All right, now he picks up. Here comes Howard. Just can't get there. Can't lock up, square up in front of him, get the hands on him. That's why Thomas was frustrated, because he knows it was his guy, Darren Howard, that ran by him and got the sack.
The 8th sack of the year for Howard. He and Kelly lead the team. Blue. David Allen back deep. Up from Andy Mitchell. Not a good one. It's going to take a Kansas State bounce. Comes all the way out outside the 45. The first down marker for Colorado was at the 46. So the woes continue. A 22-yard punt. Tough going all the way around for the Buffalo.
Papa's got a brand new bag.
PC, isn't this exciting?
Oh, yeah. I feel like I'm at a CompUSA computer superstore.
What?
Well, you know, Bob, CompUSA has a huge all-star lineup, like the software sampler, CompKids, internet department, and access to over 50,000 computer products.
Like this CompUSA PC with an Intel Pentium 2 processor, just $21,99.95. Or have one made to your exact specifications.
You know, you're right, PC. CompUSA is exactly like a football game.
Well, thank you.
Well, except that, you know, you never have to worry about getting sacked.
No.
Or gang tackled. And
only
at the
checkout.
Can we use a rigid ladder-type frame to reach new heights in performance? Can the cab-forward concept create more room, even in the trunk? When it comes to what you'll expect down the road, do we have things pretty well covered? These are the questions. This is the answer. Dodge Stratus. Starting under 14.4, 18.4 impressively equipped.
ABC Sports presentation of college football brought to you by the new Dodge. It's about change. The Nicoderm CQ Stop Smoking Patch. You bring a commitment, CQ brings the rest. National Car Rental. So what are you waiting for? Let's go. And Dean Witter. There are many ways to measure success. Dean Witter measures success one investor at a time. Bay Hill about 3 miles from here through a very overcast sky. Temperature when we started the game, they told us, was at 33 degrees. The wind chill about 20. And I don't think it's gotten any warmer. Sun has not been out the entire afternoon. And it hasn't been out for the Buffalo. Kansas State taking over first and 10. Eric Hickson jumps one tackle ahead to the 47-yard line.
Still too early for Colorado to panic. Obviously, they're down 27-6, and right now being outplayed. But, I mean, you've got 10 and a half minutes to go in the third period. You've got to get a couple defensive stops, try to get some positive things, and build on that. But right now, to be honest, Kansas State just playing so well with so much confidence. They've got that guy right there, A.J. Kristoff, a little bit baffled, a little bit frustrated.
And your job gets even harder as a defensive coordinator when your club is putting the ball on the turf, turning it over, and field position is never in your favor. Eric Hickson. It's away from one and a good run to the 45. And may have a first down for the Wildcats.
First half possessions. Look at this. It was an even ball game. They traded field goals to start. And then they took a 6-3 lead with that field goal on the third possession. And then the floodgates open. Touchdown, touchdown, punt, and a touchdown. And, of course, the three turnovers by Colorado assisted that. 14 points off of that.
And Michael Bishop really hasn't thrown the ball that often, but when he has been on the mark, and they've gone for big plays.
Yeah, he was 5 of 10 in the first half. Really didn't have to do too much. Big thing was he didn't have any interceptions. They didn't turn the ball over.
Three receivers set. Bishop, straight drop over the middle. Complete. He's got his tight end. Jared Grostadier, number 82, the senior out of St. Paul, Kansas, on the catch and another first down.
You know, the last time we were here for the Texas A&M game, they said Grostadier was a pro prospect. And when there were some scouts here, they said the guy runs a 4.7. He's got a 3.8 GPA, plays well, big, strong guy. But then Justin Swift took over, became the first teamer. They say now he is a great pro prospect at 6'3", 250, even better than Grostadier. So the bottom line is both tight ends doing well, contributing heavily, and Bishop looking for him a lot.
Right arm of Michael Bishop blessing both of the tight ends. Going to throw again. And a lot of time and a lot of wide open space to run. He's dangerous now. Touchback
Brandon Southward makes the tackle at the 20-yard line. It looked for a moment like Bishop may break that one.
You know, you hate to get down on a team. You hate to really criticize a whole lot. But right now, to be honest, Colorado's just catching blocks. They're so concerned about Bishop running, they aren't coming on a full-out rush. I mean, they're catching, they're standing, and they're dancing.
They spent a lot of time on the field in the first half. Start to get worn down at some point. Second and three. Play action. Out. Caught. Fumbled by Goolsby. And out of bounds. Boy, Colorado, even with the loose ball, can't catch a break.
Boy, I've got to tell you, you know what? That is the worst luck right there. The ball was just flirting with the sidelines. The cornerbacks are trying to get over there. Washington got there. He tried to bat it back in, but by that time it had already touched the line, and they marked it. Okay, Southward comes over. Watch his left hand, knocks it loose. There goes the football. Now here comes Washington, 37. Ball's teetering there. He tries to knock it back in, but the linesman said, nope, already touched the line. They just can't get a break.
And to add further insult, it's a first down. They move the chains. Southward has been active today, though. Been in on a lot of plays. Out of the eye, runs Hickson. Looks for room. Spins down to about the 13-yard line. Southward again in on the stop.
Southward very, very active in this defensive series, trying to get something going defensively. He's an emotional guy. He's a wild-eyed guy. He likes to try to make some tackles when he can. He's been in the last three tackles and actually forced the fumble on the pass play.
Yeah, he and Nick Ziegler, the defensive end, the two probably most emotional guys on this defense and the guys who usually get them going.
Southwood, as you said, he's a free spirit. With long-haired hikers, sleep-deprived stud.
Second and eight. Bishop finds a lane. Hit inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. That's number 90, Aaron Marshall, who brought him to the turf that time. Well, the other thing about Southward, you know, he suffered from insomnia all season long, and it's a little bit better, but it's not a whole lot better. Because of all the injuries, they needed him to play. He thought about redshirting at one point.
Guy just doesn't sleep. Does not sleep. That's why I say a sleep-deprived stud. I mean, the guy's up walking the halls at night. He loves the game of football, though.
Brings up third and three. The shotgun. Inside give to Hickson. Spin. And gets about three. We'll have to wait to see where they spot it. Southward again wrapped him up.
I don't think he got it, but if they didn't get it, I bet Snyder goes for it. It's going to be close enough where if they didn't get it, they can go for it here. Bring in their big tight end, Justin Swift. They're going to load up with the heavy package. Go two tight ends. The jumbo, and here comes Bishop. They're going for it on fourth down.
A.J. Kristoff, his defense trying to make a stop. Fourth and inches. Ball rests on the 7-yard line. Bishop straight ahead, should have had it. He gets pushed back, but he got there on the initial surge. And again, it depends on the spot.
He only had to get to the six.
Well, they're going to measure. Certainly appeared.
They've got the ball right on the six. That's where he had to go to get the first down. It looks like he's got it. The crowd's booing. They didn't like the mark, but he got the first down.
They pull it tight.
Oh, just barely. Just barely. Half the football, max.
He got it by plenty, 2 or 3 inches at least.
I told you he had it. He got it with his initial thrust. Look, boom, he's down to the six right here.
Yeah, he's actually past that mark.
All he had to do is get right in here.
Yeah, he was past that easily. So in any case, it is first and goal at the 6-yard line. Wildcats trying to tack on more on Rick Neuheisel and the Buffaloes. A couple of fullbacks in there again. Gangwish in motion. Ryan Goolsby, who scored in the first half. Inside the five, powers his way to the four, maybe the three.
defensively now. You've been in this series a long time. They moved the ball down quickly. It's been a very physical series. They've been bringing it at you. Big offensive line, we told you, is one of the biggest in the country, college or pro. So if you're the linebackers now, you may want to gamble a little bit. You may want to try to guess at your hole and come hard.
You may have to. Double tight end set. Two fullbacks out of the eye.
Pinch the corners.
Bishop going to run, but there are flags down. And we'll see if there's movement on the offensive line or if the defensive front was in the neutral zone.
Offside on the defense. Half the distance to go. We play second down.
Look at the frustration.
I see you.
By Neuheisel, and then you see everybody jump. You know, you got to gamble, you got to guess, and you got to come hard and be aggressive down there. But at the same time, you have to be disciplined.
And it's exactly what you said, actually. They were really gambling and trying to come, but you have to have some restraint. So now you've got second and goal. Just outside the two. And again, there's contact. And someone came across.
Well, you have to wonder what's jumping him, what's making him move like that. Is that Marshall again?
May have been Mau Mau, number 77.
Dead ball. False start on the offense. Huh? 5-yard penalty. Still second down.
Now you know what was drawing him. What was making him jump.
And actually, it may have been against Bishop if he bobbed the head. Because you saw no movement with the backs or on
well,
the line.
Well, something was bringing him. You saw that before. And then they do it again. Got two tights in there. Tight ends down a little bit from the quarterback. They were jumping. Got a little antsy. That could have drawn them.
And now Darnell McDonald, Gavin Perez, the two wideouts in. One tight end. There's the option and the pitch to Hickson. Looking to cut back and slam to the turf right at the 5-yard line.
I don't know how Bishop got that off. He was wrapped up when he released the ball. It was a low pitch, but Hickson did a great job just to go down and get it. He's the captain of the team. He's a senior. What a great comeback story Eric Hickson is. Missed his junior season with a broken leg. Worked hard, diligently. Stayed in the weight room.
And if you haven't done it, people have no idea how difficult it is to rehab and come back from an injury. All the work he put in. And now trying to get to pay dirt after this long drive for the Wildcats.
Defense has a chance here. Third down and 5.
Out of the gun. The throw a little bit low to Hickson. It was behind him. Bishop will be upset with himself.
That is a tough defensive series right there. Down inside the 10-yard line. Especially even after they jumped off sides and they moved it inside the 5. They fought, they battled, they scratched, they clawed, and they've stopped them here for the first 3 plays. It brings up 4th down and 5. And that'll hold them to at least a field goal.
Martin Gramatica comes on for the field goal try. It'll be from 22 yards, one of the 3 finalists for the Grozer Award. Had a 52-yarder in the first half and nails this one. So Kansas State on the board here in the second half. But a good stop, and maybe something at least positive to point to for Colorado. Stopping it after it was second and goal from the 2. Gramatica puts 3 on the board.
At BASF, we don't make the boat, we make it faster. We don't make the safety seat, we make it more comfortable. We don't make the studio, we make it quieter. We don't make the golf clubs, we make them more powerful. At BASF, we don't make a lot of the products you buy, we make a lot of the products you buy better. BASF.
Owen Moore works at the Liberty Mutual Research Center.
Hey, Randy, use an underarm motion.
Thanks, Doc.
Owen studies how you can do your job better and safer.
Reaching out.
Ensuring workplace safety. That's the freedom of liberty. Liberty Mutual.
For years, you've heard the debate.
Duracell.
Energizer. Which battery lasts longer?
Duracell.
Recent tests Energizer. Prove that Duracell outlasts Energizer in the devices you use most. Better make it the alkaline battery proven to last longer. Better make it Duracell.
Can lightweight aluminum cylinder heads enhance engine performance? Is it possible to see the future in a rearview mirror? If race cars inspired us to use a double wishbone suspension, can you handle that? These are the questions. This is the answer. Dodge Stratus. Starting under 14.4, 18.4 impressively equipped.
Time now for the Burger King play of the day. Brian Griese with some trickery here over to Charles Woodson. He looks upfield and then back to Brian Griese, and he takes it down to the 1 yard line, setting up Michigan's first touchdown as they're looking to remain unbeaten. They lead Wisconsin 16-10. Terry.
All right, John, still a good one going on there. The sandwich game, as you call it. Good one next week. As well, the scoring drive, 13 plays, and they went 50 yards, but they were stopped inside the five.
Yeah, the bottom line is Kansas State is pretty daggone good. Only lost to Nebraska. They're being emphatic today, 30-6.
Here's Ben Kelly at his own 2 yard line, going to bring it out, looking for a couple of blocks. Demetric Denmark with a tackle at the 14 yard line, a good stop by the cornerback. Well, next Saturday, America's biggest road show. Well, it rolls into Ann Arbor. This one of the great matchups this season. Can Ohio State and John Cooper finally beat Michigan, number 4 and number 2, next Saturday at noon Eastern time here on ABC? The Rose Bowl question still up for grabs. And the rest of your lineup here on ABC next week. Check your local listings for the games in your area. Call your cable operator for those on pay-per-view. College football season winding down and a lot in question still. Pass out complete. The first catch of the afternoon for Phil Savoy. We've been wondering where he's been and why Hessler hasn't gone to him.
You know, that's a matchup that we said at the beginning of the game would be critical. That would be key. I mean, you've got Savoy, who's outstanding and a big receiver at 6'3". Came into the game with 29 receptions, working against a freshman who's 5'9 and a half.
Got more yards in the air this year than any other Colorado receiver, too. And a big play, man. This one thrown over the middle, it was tipped. And it was, that was Jerome Evans again. That's the third time this afternoon that he's got a hand on a Hessler pass.
That was big old Evans, 99. He's going to be right in the middle of your screen. Or 98 rather, 6'6". Look, can't get through. He's being blocked by Wade, and so he gets his hand up. That's huge.
You know what, though? That almost hit him in the armpit. Now, that ball was not well thrown.
Well, we said that earlier, that Hessler's got to find the creases and the alleys to throw, and he doesn't do that.
They're calling him big third downs all game long, but here it comes again, 3rd and 2. And they run it this time over the left side. Troutman's got a lane. And across midfield, finally brought down and run out of bounds at the 38-yard line. So on 3rd and 2, a huge gain of 39 for Herschel Troutman.
Before the game, actually this past week, the coaches said Troutman's more quick than he is fast, but he's effective. And boy, that play really exemplified it. He used his quickness to get through the hole, but he's not really overly fast. Look, the quickness gets him by, gets him through, gets him past the lineman McCoy, and then he gets tracked down from behind by Chapman.
Number 5 rusher in Colorado history. Hessler going deep, double coverage. Chapman almost intercepted it. Nothing open. That ball didn't have a chance.
He just let this thing fly. You know, I think he was actually throwing it away. But if you're going to do it, you better really let it wing and get it away from the safeties. I don't know why he was throwing there anyway. He had double coverage.
Chapman has made some big plays this year. And a couple of big ones today, too. Recovering that fumble down at the goal line in the first half. Will they come on the blitz? Simonet. He's got Hessler. Now he gets away. but he won't get away from the second tackle. Joe Bob Clements on the sack.
They were coming off both corners with a blitz. It was supposed to be a keeper on the corner, and they ran right into the blitz. Here it comes off the corner. Boom. He says, all right, look, I'm in trouble here. Goes back backside, but they're coming that way as well. Well, you got to like that. I mean, you've got Howard coming one way, you got Clements coming the other way, and you got the linebackers chasing you down in between. There's Clements, 46.
Clements, a former walk-on. Run is Hessler again. Incomplete. No chance again.
Good job. Just unloaded because he had Howard and Oaks coming after him hard again. Hey, I want to tell you something now. They're just laying their errors back. I mean, they're just coming and letting it all loose.
Now, that's the look that's been on Rick Neuheisel's face for much of this year. And Bill Snyder doesn't show much emotion, but you know, he knows this is a good one. We talked to him and his assistant coaches and some of the players. They think that this defense may be as good as that 95 defense.
You know, and that 95 defense, which led the nation, Tom Osborne said that that defense was as good as anybody in the country in the last 20 years. They say this one's just almost as good.
Nick Peach. This is another short kick into the wind. They're trying to keep it low against that wind. Goes out of bounds. Well, tomorrow at 1:30 Eastern time, 12:30 Central, we've got soccer action coming your way. The U.S. national team battling El Salvador. The U.S., of course, already clinched a berth in the World Cup next season in France. El Salvador trying to do the same tomorrow at 12:30 Central time right here on ABC. It was a punt of only 25 yards. And Michael Bishop bringing the offense out. And they start outside the 25-yard line. Gives it to Mike Lawrence. Can't find any room on the left side and brought down right at the line of scrimmage. Ryan Black, number 6, the strong safety, made the stop.
You know what's interesting about Michael Bishop? Is look at John Hessler, who, you talk about a frustrated day. He's been hit, he's been knocked down. Missed some passes. It's been a frustrating day. But when you look at Bishop, when the game is close, and we've seen this throughout the year, he wants the ball. He wants to be running the ball, throwing the ball, or doing something. Here the game is 30-6. It's a little bit out of control. He's just distributing now. He's become a distributor. Hickson and Lawrence are getting them involved. Goolsby, of course, the big touchdown and the power drives.
And again to the fullback, Goolsby. The up back and across the 30 to the 32. And we saw Hessler a moment ago dejected on the sideline. Lewis Johnson has a report on him right now. Lewis?
That's because Neuheisel is all over him. He brought him back to the bench just a moment ago, and he pulled the board out, and he started to draw and talk about what the defense of Kansas State was doing. He told him he's frustrated that he's just not hitting the passes. That's what he wants him to focus on. But after he got all over him, he had to buffer it a little bit and told him just to hang in there, and somehow they'd come back and win this game. So who knows about that?
Well, it's a misunderstood relationship and always has been. People see Rick Neuheisel get hard and yell and scream at him, but they admire each other. They like each other. They've been good for each other. Kind of a love-hate.
But it has not been a good year. So there's a lot of yelling going on. Bishop throws it on the run. All the way down to Burnett. He overthrows Everett Burnett, the junior. But Michael Bishop, every week, continues to do things that just amaze you. Now, last week against Kansas, he threw one, just rocketed one on a dead run off the wrong foot. And that ball just explodes out of his right arm.
Phenomenal athlete, I'll tell you that.
So James Garcia, and he got hit by Charrington. This one's coming back. It's down at the 17-yard line, and Garcia is still on the turf. That was not pretty.
You have to wonder how Charrington didn't block it.
You know, Charrington came hard and then looked like he stopped. Watch this. Charrington has the ball. He has it blocked. He's coming out of the left hand. Look, and seems to pull back. Instead of going after the block at that point, it's like, I don't want to hurt him. I don't want to rough him. I don't want a penalty. Look at him. He's actually pulling his hands back. Got alligator arms. He should have just gone for the block. If he was going to go into the gap, block the punt, then it's all legal.
And it looked to me, as you said, like he had the block easily.
It looked to me, I thought he was going to block it and then pulled back.
First down and 10, Kansas State 46.
Penalties, mistakes, turnovers. Story of the day and much of the year for Colorado. So the Wildcats keep the ball and they're outside their own 46-yard line. A lot of time in. Time is gone now. Bishop hit just as he let it go. Lyon Olsen, the senior out of Lakewood, Colorado, made the hit.
That is the end of the third quarter.
So the third Kansas quarter State has come to a close. It's been all Kansas State. We're back after this message and a word from our ABC station.
We have the how-to clinics where we show the customer how to do the project themselves.
It's very hands-on. The customers are encouraged to come up to the front and actually start grouting the tile or spackling the drywall. It's excellent.
They've gotten some grout in their fingernails. They realize, no, it's not all that tough.
They get involved. They get pumped. They take notes.
They want to learn it, and you're going
to
teach them.
And I think it's encouraging people to do things they thought might be too hard.
To have people go home and do that and come back and say, boy, that was a lot easier than you even made it seem. That's where the satisfaction is.
Can we enhance performance by simply moving a battery? Is it possible to combine the ease of an automatic with the fun of a manual? Is everyone comfortable with the concept of cab-forward design? These are the questions. This is the answer. Dodge Stratus. Starting under 14.4, 18.4 impressively equipped.
Tonight, Bobby's finally ready to make his move.
I like her.
But not with the lawyer you expected. An all-new Practice ABC tonight.
And do you take this woman to be your lawfully wedded wife in good times and in bad all the days of your life?
Wow. Could I have a little more time on this?
Amoco Silver. You expect more from a leader.
Sports cars are known for the way they move you. But can they really move you? Presenting Sonoma by GMC with 180 horsepower Vortec V6, a ZQ8 sports suspension, and this innovative third door, Sonoma can really move you. Sonoma by GMC, where sports car meets pickup.
Buy a new 98 Sonoma now. Get $750 cash back or low 4.9% APR GMAC financing. See your Colorado GMC dealer today.
Scouting for food.
Real life, real solutions.
This is college football on ABC Sports.
It's the kind of day it's been for Colorado. Here's Charrington right here coming on the block. Watch what he does. Rolling. Just playing tentatively, stopping, oops. And then instead of getting the block on the punt, he gets the flag for the penalty for roughing the kicker. You've got to untie yourself. You've got to be free. You've just got to play football with reckless abandon. And right now, Colorado's not. They're playing tentatively.
In all ways. You talked about it with Michael Bishop. They're afraid to let him get outside. They're afraid of that containment problem. But even going after the punter. And by the way, we saw James Garcia on the sideline, and he does appear to be okay. So it's Kansas State football as we open up the fourth quarter. Colorado showing blitz. The pitch outside, and Morris trying to turn the corner. Cut back, Sutter brings him down at the 47-yard line.
Great pitch by Bishop, great play. But I want to tell you something. Bishop took a lick. He gets up off the ground looking out of his ear hole. He shakes it off, though, and comes back.
Third down, three.
He got knocked right on his butt, still got the pitch off and made the play.
And there doesn't seem to be any problem at all with the ankle. He had one earlier in the game, and it's an injury that he's dealt with the last 4 or 5 weeks. Finally 100%.
Folks, keep in mind, Colorado has not lost to Kansas State since 1984. They're 11-0-1. So Kansas State is hungry. 30-6 is not enough for them. They want to make a statement.
Option this way. Bishop going to catch it. Brought down well short of a first down. Let's get an update again from John Saunders in New York. John?
Barry, in the ACC, North Carolina against Clemson. Chris Kelldorf in at quarterback. Oscar Davenport out for the season. 58 yards to LC Stevens. Stevens with three catches for 169 yards to that point. The next play, they get the touchdown and lead 17-10. Terry.
All right, John, I didn't think they were going to bring Stevens down at all watching that, but North Carolina coming off that Florida State loss. This one makes a right angle bounce and out of bounds at the 12-yard line. So a 34-yard punt by Garcia, who's back in after that hit by Charrington. 30-6, Wildcats.
Chevy Blazer with the driver control system, a little security in an insecure world.
Let's see. Oh, it says you've been seen in the movies.
That should read at the movies.
And you've built models, but never really actually modeled. Well, quite frankly, you the man!
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
Is she my co-star?
Now she is.
And over East Chef.
Take these back.
They're
over hard. Try again.
I think I liked you better smoking. He's quitting cold turkey.
Hey, I'm quitting myself. Can I suggest?
Nicoderm CQ. Does that help?
If it didn't, you'd be wearing these eggs.
With a 24-hour stream of medicine, Nicoderm CQ calms even nasty cravings. It's the power to calm, the power to comfort, the power to quit successfully.
You know what? I like you better not smoking.
Next Saturday, don't miss the Big Ten Game of the Year. Michigan hosts Ohio State with a trip to the Rose Bowl and national title hopes on the line.
Well, you have to go back a long time to find a Kansas State win over Colorado, 1984. Guess what? They did it with some offense, but they also did it with defense and special teams. The onside kick, the run back, the interception. Colorado an awful year that year. 1-10, the last sub-500 season for them. But Jim Dickey, a great season for Kansas State. They're trying to do it today. It looks like they will. Bill Snyder has waited for this chance. His best. To throw. Got Marcus Stiggers with a catch at the 23 and close to a first down.
He's got the first down to move the chains, and Hessler, for one of the rare times today, stood up and actually threw that like he meant it. I mean, he had a lot of force behind the ball, a lot of velocity on it, and threw it to the spot. That's what Hessler was being told on the sidelines by Neuhauser. Just step up and throw it. Stop thinking. Just rely on your athletic ability, and Hessler has plenty of that.
Go out there and play thinking about your mistakes or thinking about what the coach thinks of your mistakes. You just got to play. Bill Savoia's second catch of the afternoon. Fights his way up to the 32-yard line.
That's two in a row that he's planted his foot, stepped into it, and I mean just whistled the ball. He's playing with some resolve now.
That's second and three. This time Trotman gets the call. Got a first down. And Chapman on his back, bringing him down at the 41-yard line. Well, it does get easier when you're in the fourth quarter and you're down 30-6. I mean, you've got nothing to lose. So you do just go out there and you throw the football and you make plays. But that's the John Hessler that Colorado fans were used to the last few years.
Yeah, and I'm surprised that they have been held to 6 points. That shows you how tough, how strong, and how talented K-State is.
Points over the last four games. Savoy with another catch, and he's close to a first down. Well, Thanksgiving weekend here on ABC Sports. one of the old favorites, the Skins game. You'll see four of America's top players, Tiger Woods, Tom Lehman, Marco Mira, and defending champion Fred Couples, big money riding on every hole. The Skins game, November 29th and 30th, right here on ABC Sports. Always a great show.
Talking about being surprised that Colorado's been held to 6 points. They've averaged 38 points over the last five games with 405 yards of total offense per game. And here they only have the two field goals.
Savoy's third catch gets them the first down by about an inch. Well, remember, at the conclusion of today's game, we will select the Chevrolet most valuable player of the game from each team. To date, Chevrolet has awarded over $6.5 million to scholarship funds of America's colleges and universities. The first sign of life, at least in the second half, for the Buffaloes. And movement on the offensive line drew Darren Howard across.
He was lined up against Shane Cook. Both of them moved. Which one moved first? I'm not sure. We'll see if Howard was in a neutral zone or whether Cook got him there.
Dead ball. False start on the offense. Still first down.
Put that one on Shane Cook.
That's what Rick Neuheisel was trying to say, that the defense came across the neutral zone to draw him out.
First down, 15, 46-yard line.
Well, the young coach for Colorado experiencing adversity really for the first time this season. But he's been a long shot before. He's dealt with it before. He's a player at UCLA and as a coach, the assistant coach. This one through the hands of Phil Savoy inside the 15-yard line.
Those two have been battling the entire game. Look at the smile on Savoy, because Carter and Savoy have been talking, banging, bumping all day. Watch this. Now, the right hand of Savoy comes out. He's trying to keep Carter off of him. Now he's got the ball, but he can't get his right hand back in. Carter slaps it away. Now watch Carter. He turns and starts talking to him. Those guys have had a battle all day long.
He just had a hole in that right arm. You're right. Almost made the one-handed catch. Michelle Trellman, Damian McIntosh brings him down at the 48.
So what was a terrific drive going. Now they miss on the big play. They had the movement, which moved them back. So now they find themselves what is going to be third down and forever, a taxi cab ride.
Third and about 12 coming up.
49-yard line.
Fine line between moving those chains and getting in a situation you don't want to be in against this defense. Here they come. Gets out, got a lot of space to make up though. Brought down right at midfield.
Ball carrier number 7, John Hessler.
Darren Howard, a young, talented sophomore out of St. Petersburg, Florida.
Tell you what, it's fourth down and over 10, I'd still go for it. You got to go for it. You got 11:24 to play. You're down 30-6. What do you have to lose?
Fourth down, 10. 49-yard line.
That's exactly what Rick Neuheisel's going to do. Three receiver set. You got one back in the backfield. That's Charrington. Deep drop for Hessler. Trying to set up a screen. Throws it away. It was read perfectly by Kansas State, and it never developed.
Colorado turns it over.
Well, they turn it over on downs. Disappointment continuing for Rick Neuheisel.
America has always had a love affair with cars. And since 1922, we've been there whenever you've needed us. That's why we're America's favorite auto insurer.
And as we celebrate a 75th year, we, the agents
and employees of State Farm,
would just like to say thanks for being there, too.
Duke, cop. He loves his job. And the third door in a Chevy S10. It's one of a kind, just like Duke. Chevy S10, like a rock.
Papa's got a brand new bag.
Sports presentation of college football brought to you by Bud Light. If you want great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light. Micron Electronics. Now you know. All your computing needs are just a phone call away. Chevrolet Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. And Smith Barney, a member of the Travelers Group. Smith Barney, they make money the old-fashioned way. They earn it.
Ominous clouds and a quarterback who does a lot of damage. That's what Colorado has faced this afternoon here in Manhattan, Kansas. And it's the Wildcats taking over first and 10 after the incomplete pass on fourth down by the Buffalo. Long count movement.
Yeah, but see, that one's got to be on Bishop. Bishop started to pull out without the ball and drew the defense across.
Dead ball, false start on the offense. Still first down.
Take a look at this. Watch your quarterback now. A lot of times they'll bob their head, but this time he's just pulling out. I think he had the wrong snap count. As soon as he started the move, that just triggers the reaction, and everybody comes across, and Mau Mau followed him right through.
And no one else moved on the offense. Backs him up, first and 15.
What a delight Bishop is, man. We had a great visit with him yesterday, talked with him a great deal. But I do believe the same thing you do. He just does not believe that he can lose. But he's a winner and believes he'll win every time out.
But it's a quiet confidence. It's not an arrogance in talking to him. The inside Gilmore hits him with a hole. Up front, tough running across midfield. Well, big game for Michigan today and next week. John Saunders, what's going on with the Wolverines?
Terry, they may have pushed this one away. Chris Howard. Watch the power in his legs. Stopped at the one-yard line and then just pushes everyone into the end zone. Michigan now leading by 16, looking ahead to Ohio State. Right now, 26-10. Terry.
And John, they have to win this one to make next week important.
That looks like that run we had here by Goolsby earlier.
Sure did, didn't it? Second effort by the fullback. This time the tailback. It's Hickson. Right into Mike Phillips, after a gain of about four, though, and they're maybe a yard, yard and a half short of a first down. Mike Phillips, the senior out of Marrero, Louisiana, just outside of New Orleans, but a four-year starter. One of the guys who's been injured, had the shoulder sprain all year long, been battling that. Ty Gregorak came in and started as a true freshman, took his spot for at least a game, but you do have to feel for the seniors on this club, looking at a year in which it's the worst year in a while for the Buffaloes.
Well, CU had trouble stopping the run against Texas, Texas A&M, Missouri, and again here today against Kansas State.
So third and one, they give it up front to Matt Gamewish, his first carry of the afternoon. He's got a first down. He's led the way a couple of times for Goolsby.
You know, the last couple of plays, Kendall Jaycox has gotten the key block while they're starting the run. This time he doesn't really knock anybody down. Watch him, though, the center, 74. Watch him, he comes through. Here's one block. Here's another. He's still in front of the ball carrier. And he's looking for somebody else to hit. Now, the guy's 6'1", 320 pounds. He's the center. He was scoped. Had knee surgery the beginning of the season. The guy just has fun playing. He's an outstanding player. And right now, he's just leading the way, trying to melt the clock, and let's get out of here.
9:08 and counting until they get to the locker room. Gonna run it again. Hickson wrapped up and caught behind the line of scrimmage. Run down by Nick Ziegler, the junior out of Huntington Beach, California. Lewis Johnson.
Hey, guys, let me tell you a quick funny story about Michael Bishop. I talked to KSU coordinator, offensive coordinator Ron Hudson before the game. He told me that when Bishop came out of the locker room before the, right at the beginning of the game, he saw something fluttering in the air, and he said, "What is that, snow?" And they said, "No, it's not snow. Don't worry." The guy's from Texas. He's never seen snow. He's never played in a game this cold. But on a serious note, Schneider told us that he is not worried at all about his skills in terms of throwing into this wind because he's got such a rocket strong arm.
Boy, he does have that. bad. I mean, receivers have had broken fingers and lacerations from the laces. But he's an awfully strong quarterback, awfully good quarterback. One loss in his career.
Going to run the option this time. Hit by Ryan Black, though. Ball's loose, but he was down.
Tackle by number six, Ryan Black.
Ryan Black, the senior out of Phoenix, and one of the two walk-ons who start at the safety positions in that secondary for Colorado. He had more tackles a year ago than anyone else in the Big 12, 154, and it was more than any defensive back in Colorado history.
He was a high school star, came to Colorado, as you mentioned, as a walk-on. He was ready to transfer, wanted off the bus. Said, I'm going to get out of here. And just then, the coaches said, hey, we've got a scholarship. You come on back to Boulder.
Yeah, I wanted off the plane, literally. He had a conversation with McCartney, and he talked him into staying. Gave him a scholarship and stayed right in Boulder. So it's a timeout taken by the Wildcats. To talk things over, they lead it 30-6.
Thrifty has some great numbers for you, starting when you call this number, 1-800-4-CARS. Get great cars and great rates like a Dodge Neon or other compact for just $29.95 a day. Plus, earn up to 2,750 Advantage miles from Thrifty with our rent-to-earn program. You have our number, 1-800-4-CARS, or call your professional travel agent. It's fast, it's affordable, and best of all, it's Thrifty.
This is a handsaw. And this is Handy. The cordless circular saw. Powered by VersaPac, built by Black & Decker.
New Chevy Blazer with the driver control system. A little security in an insecure world.
The aluminum in your car radiator is as thin as this sheet, and it's the only thing between you and a breakdown. But Prestone Antifreeze bonds with aluminum, forming a zone of protection against corrosion and temperature extremes. Protect your car in the Prestone Zone.
Jerry Faust era at Notre Dame, as Smith Barney remembers one of the great moments, not for Jerry Faust in Notre Dame, but one of the most exciting moments, I guess, in college football's past. And that was a good one.
Yeah, I worked that game with Keith Jackson, and that was fun. It was fun back then. Jerry Faust had some tough years, but what a kind man.
Bob Davies starting out, finding out what it's all about, all the pressure at the helm for Notre Dame. Now you talk about turnarounds, and Bill Snyder has certainly engineered one of the greatest you're ever going to see here at Kansas State. Bishop is pounded to the turf. Ball is loose. It's picked up and down to the 33-yard line. Ziegler with the hit. Jesse Warren with the recovery.
Look out here. Now temper's starting to flare. Frustration. Bishop got up from the first hit, started to run down the field. They hit him again.
Some of his teammates trying to protect him.
All right, the first hit is legal. He doesn't even see the blitz coming from that side. Boom, that's a legal hit, and I mean he was just decked. All right, now the ball starts to get away. Now he got up and started to chase the ball carrier and took another lick.
A lot of frustration coming out from the Colorado side. It looks like Michael Bishop is okay. So this time, it's Kansas State turning the football over. That's been the story, but it's been the story for the Buffaloes. Hessler throws on first down and was tipped but complete. at the 30-yard line, and they finally get a break. Marcus Stiggers on the catch.
Yeah, that's great concentration by Stiggers because, as you said, the ball was tipped. It actually became a knuckleball after that point. He stopped, broke down, and waited for it like a catcher waiting for a breaking ball.
First break that Colorado has got in a long while. Straight drop. Hessler over the middle. He's got his tailback. Troutman looks for room, dancing inside the 15. And down to the 13-yard line before the shot. Carter going to wrap him up.
It's been all Kansas State this afternoon, but give Colorado some credit now. They're not going to lay down and throw up the white flag. They're still battling.
Throw inside the five, dropped. Stiggers can't hold on to it.
See, now I thought that was a reception. I thought he ran with it twice, two steps with his the ball on his fingertips before he lost it.
Not sure he ever really had it, though. He had been bobbling it.
Well, let's take a look at it. Let's see. It was close. It was a great catch, or it looked like it was going to be a great catch. Right on his fingertips, he's got it. One, two.
No, never had it.
It was when he started to try to tuck it away that he lost it.
Actually caught the back end of the football just to get it.
Yeah.
Initially, it was a good catch. And the snow starts to fall.
Yeah, we had some flurries in the first half, now coming down pretty good.
Most of the flurries in the first half, the peanut shells of Tim Brandt. But now, actual snow falling here in Manhattan.
Partner, you're killing me tonight.
And Rick Neuheisel wants to talk things over. First real good opportunity in the second half for a score for the Buffaloes.
Like a rock, I was strong as I could be. Like a rock, nothing ever got to me.
As the years go by, some slow down and take it easy. Some don't.
Like a rock.
Chevy, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
Owen Moore works at the Liberty Mutual Research Center.
Hey, Randy, use an underarm motion.
Thanks, Doc.
Owen studies how you can do your job better and safer.
Reaching out.
Ensuring workplace safety. That's the freedom of liberty. Liberty Mutual.
The Panasonic Razor. Shave wet or shave dry. Your choice. Your shave. Rinse clean. Work hard. Play hard. Shave your way. Panasonic.
You can keep your car looking clean, but you've got to keep your engine clean, too. Newly formulated Valvoline DuraBlend motor oil is a synthetic blend that suspends the dirt, unburned fuel, and water that cause harmful deposits and reduces oil burn-off. DuraBlend protects vital engine parts so your engine runs cleaner and better longer. It outperforms all leading conventional motor oils because a car can look great. But it's what's inside that counts. Valvoline DuraBlend.
Oh, winter is here. Christmas can't be far away. How many shopping days until Christmas? Well, this guy doesn't care. Santa Claus. Boy, what a scene, huh? 6:37 left in this one. The Buffaloes, for the first time in the second half, threatening. Hessler over the middle to the end zone, caught, touchdown, Savoy.
And look who it is, working against Carter, the freshman. They've been battling all day. Carter certainly has won a lot of them. He held him catchless in the first half. But this one goes to Savoy.
Fourth touchdown of the year for Phil Savoy, the senior out of Washington, D.C. And they're going to go for two here. 30-12, the score at this point. Wayne Charrington has come in. Or Herschel Troutman. Line Green to the far side. You've got Marcus Stiggers to the near along with Baron Cheverini. Now three receivers to the near side. Cheverini in motion. Hessler trying to run it in, finds a seam, gets there.
Colorado now two touchdowns and two two-point conversions away from tying this thing. That's a stretch, but it's
well, 16 points in 6.5 minutes.
6.5 minutes to go. That's a big stretch.
It's a stretch, but...
But if you're Colorado, obviously you got to be thinking that way. Here's the matchup we've been watching all day. They've been bumping, they've been clawing, and they've been pushing all day. Now here's the perfect pass. Savoy's got it right between the eight and his ear. Now that ball's well thrown. And look how he plants that back foot and throws with velocity. I'm really surprised they weren't doing that more.
The last two drives, too, Timmy, Hessler's really come out and thrown aggressive passes, as you said. Planted, thrown strikes. The drive before that did not work out, but he looked good the last two drives. Well, Monday night here on ABC, meet real people who looked death in the face and made it. Watch the incredible real-life stories on an all-new I Survived a Disaster Monday night on ABC. Check your local listings for the time. And, of course, ABC's NFL Monday Night Football goes to Miami, the Bills and the Dolphins, an AFC East showdown. Always a good one. Live at 9 Eastern time right here on ABC.
AFC East still up for grabs. It's been crazy this year. Dan Marino in and out. It looks like, all right, they're going to be in first place, and they drop back out. Dan hurt his ankle, and they put him back in. They win, beat the Jets.
Now, Phil Savoy, a big second half after being shut out in the first half.
Starting to snow pretty hard right now.
Nothing on the ground as of yet.
No, but I'd wear a shoe and a sock.
Except the bare foot of Jason Leslie.
Now, you'd think your parents would teach you better than that in the snow to wear some shoes and socks.
Now, do you go for an onside kick here, Timmy?
Yeah, I definitely would. I mean, you've got 6.5 to go. You're 2 touchdowns and 2 2-point conversions away. If you don't go for the straight onside, then look for the open areas and just try to pooch it there and let your sprinters get it.
The onside, here it is. I don't think it even went 10 before Kansas State went up and got the ball.
It didn't. It didn't. That was not the kind of onside you like.
Boy, it wasn't bouncing. Never had a bad hop.
And it wasn't kicked hard, so it was easy to feel. He kind of missed it. He wanted a dribbler that they could chase down right in the middle. It wasn't going to be a bouncer, but he didn't get it all. He wants it to go straight. Instead, he kind of hit it sideways and did not put anything behind it, so it just kind of didn't make it to 10, number one. The only one that could recover it at that point was Kansas State.
Number 88, Troy Hackney, a wide receiver of Hayes, Kansas. Coming up with that football. The Wildcats take over. Michael Bishop still in, as is the first team offense. Mike Lawrence goes off the right side. And, you know, this is a situation where Bill Snyder obviously has got to be thrilled with what they've done to this point, but probably hoped that he could have put this one away a little earlier. It allowed Colorado to make the drive.
They sure have played well, I'll tell you that. They've been dominant early and ever since.
6:20 left here in the fourth. Timeout on the field. We'll step away as well.
There comes a time when you realize you've come about as far as you can on your own. And if you want your investments to go further, you're going to need someone with the expertise and the resources to help you go the distance. It's not an admission of failure. It's an admission of success. It's an acknowledgement of what you've got at stake here. That moment of truth when you say to yourself, okay, no more fun and games.
Smith Barney, they make money the old-fashioned way. They earn it.
To get the most out of your digital satellite system, you need DirecTV. And for expert advice and guaranteed low prices on your new system, you need Circuit City. We're your DSS experts, and we'll show you how to see more sports, movies, and pay-per-view than on any other system. Right now, get the last 6 weeks of 97 NFL Sunday Ticket free when you buy any DSS and sign up for monthly DirecTV Total Choice programming. Now at Circuit City.
Try Chili's Ranch and Filet, a beautifully carved 8-ounce tenderloin, slow grilled to perfection and placed on awesome blossom strings. Served with skillet potato cakes and grilled veggies, only at Chili's.
KSU Stadium Wagner Field on a cold Saturday here in Manhattan, Kansas. And the Wildcats have this one in hand. If time permits, remember, stay tuned for the Thrifty Car Rental postgame report featuring scores and highlights across the country. 6:20 left here in the fourth quarter. Second and 10, they give it straight ahead to the fullback, Goolsby.
Just inside the 40, almost to the 39.
Well, you look at the North Division, Kansas State just behind Nebraska with one loss. That's who they lost to, of course, Colorado at 3-3. So Kansas State still very much in line for an Alliance Bowl bid. It depends on what happens with the teams, of course, ahead of them. They're number 8 in the country right now.
Yeah, no question about that. I know that there are those that say, well, they'll probably go to the Cotton, but they are still in the hunt for an Alliance. And that means a lot of money. I mean, we're talking $8.6 million to each Alliance participant.
Here goes Bishop following his fullback goals. They got a first down, hops his way inside the 30, down to the 27. A gain of 13. Well, the fans here earlier throwing out tortillas. They want to go to the Fiesta Bowl, and that certainly is a possibility. Now you look at the Big 12 bowl bids, and the Alliance, of course, part of it, and then the Cotton, Holiday, and on down the line.
Well, the Fiesta Bowl gets the fourth and sixth choice in the Alliance mix, with the first or the final slot reserved for the Big East champion. So they would have a chance there. I mean, you're thinking about Virginia Tech or Syracuse, but K-State could fall into the fourth slot, especially if Arizona State lost or breaks out of a four-way tie in the Pac-10.
Stopped running the line of scrimmage, but he brought about four Buffalo defenders with him. Well, the thing that Kansas State does bring is a lot of people to a bowl, and that certainly helps them. They'll bring 40, 50,000 people to a bowl, and you look at the top 10 and what they are doing today. Georgia losing, but other than that, everyone else having won or winning. Tennessee, of course, later on ESPN2.
I think if Colorado could somehow beat Nebraska this week, that's a tall order, because they've got to get one more win to get six. If they were to get that big upset, then they'd go to the Aloha.
Goolsby again down to the 20-yard line. Well, that's what they were hoping, that they would win today and maybe go to the Aloha Bowl, as you say. A win over Nebraska, not out of the question, but that's
a tall order.
That is tough,
yeah,
even at home. So you're looking today at Bill Snyder moving to 9-1, 6-1 in the Big 12, number 8 in the nation. They continue to roll. At the end of the 80s, when he came in, Kansas State was 136-1 to close out the 80s. He's 63-37-1. An amazing job. Third and 2, Mike Lawrence at his own man, and kept going. He's got a first down. They'll move the chains again. And even this has been impressive, this last drive, Jimmy. A different style offense. They keep it on the ground the entire way and using up all this clock.
I have to tell you again, I'm just as impressed with Bishop as I was the first time I saw him. Guy is a phenomenal athlete. I mean, he's big, he's strong, he's got great vision, tremendous confidence in a quiet way. He's a terrific leader, has the strongest arm in the country, bar none. The strongest arm in the country. Not necessarily the most accurate. That's where he needs improvement. But what a great runner, too.
How many players, how many quarterbacks in the NFL do you think have a stronger arm?
Well, we had some NFL scouts here at the Texas A&M game, and they said he had the strongest arm in the country, bar none, on any level.
Not just in college football.
Right.
Wow. Well, he can throw it a long way.
And he knows that. He knows he has one of the strongest arms, if not the strongest.
He'll tell you.
Any level, pro, college.
He will tell you. You're right. And he uses it. Second down and 8. Where are the numbers rushing for Michael Bishop? More yards than any quarterback in one season in Kansas State history. game, in with over 400 on the year. Going to keep it again, and he pitches out of the way. There's no point to down to the end zone. Going to get credit for the touchdown, but this play's made by Bishop again. Here, look, waits to the very last second, and then there's nobody left to take Lawrence. That's because Bishop took it down. He went past the defensive end. He got down toward the defensive back. They had the back commit. Once he committed to Bishop, the late pitch to Lawrence, and there was nobody left to stop it. Out the lights. The party's over.
And it may have been over for some time.
It was, but if you're on the sideline for Colorado, you're still holding out hope with 6.5 minutes left when you pulled within 2 touchdowns. But now, you can't hold out hope no matter who you are. The greatest offense right now has got to be saying, are you kidding me? This one is in the books. Probably, as you said, has been in the books since halftime.
And let's give him credit. John Urban was the man who just kicked that extra point coming on for Grammatica. Well, been an amazing job by Bill Snyder rebuilding this program, and really, he told us the way he did it is a very simple formula.
In all honesty, I know it sounds trite, but we have just tried to manage our youngsters in a way that we can motivate them to get themselves a little bit better day in and day out. I mean, that I know that's old coach talk, but that's really all it has been. And I didn't have a perception of what today would be like. 9 years ago, I didn't look down the road to this point and say, you know, I think we can be here, I think we can be there, I think we can have this accomplished or that. I really didn't.
What's been impressive about the way Bill Snyder has done it is he's done it his way. He doesn't care what anybody thinks about his program. He's doing it his way. And he sure does take care of protect his kids.
There goes Ben Kelly. Brought down at the 36-yard line, right? In fact, 53 yards from the end zone on the opening kickoff, but not much since then. It's an extracurricular again after the play, and a penalty marker down. Well, Snyder, you look at the job, and not to overstate it, but let's be honest, too. Manhattan, Kansas is not exactly New York City or Chicago or something. It's not easy to recruit here. But he's been able to build a tradition that has attracted kids, attracted a lot of players out of the state of Kansas, and he's made this program into one which is respected throughout the country.
Well, he's done it this way. He's done it this year with junior college transfers.
Yep.
Dead ball. Personal foul. On the return team. It'll be first and 10.
This part is fun. Especially if you're at home playing in what is your last home game. So 2:07 left. Great drop. Hessler throws on the run. Savoy with a catch. And out to the 37-yard line.
This is the best Hessler's looked in a long time here in this fourth quarter. Because he's just winging it now. He's just relying on his athletic ability. He's not hesitating. He's not playing tentatively. He's just going. He's pulling the trigger, making decisions and going with it. Flow freely.
Yeah, you learn, really, through college athletics being around it and also professional sports. Those who are most effective can handle the pressure but don't realize the pressure they're in. As Troutman makes the catch, and Cimino the tackle. A lot of times those who are not cursed with self-awareness in terms of their surroundings are the ones who relax and just let it rip. You can't be thinking about making mistakes. Well, tomorrow night on ABC, Richard Dreyfuss and Elijah Wood start a brand new version of Oliver Twist on the Wonderful World of Disney at 7 o'clock Eastern, 6 Central. Then Martin Sheen, Gail O'Grady, and Lori Loughlin star in an ABC miniseries event, Medusa's Child, tomorrow night
right here on ABC. Timmy, we've been around the country. We've seen the top teams, Penn State, Florida State, Michigan, Ohio State around. After watching Kansas State now for the second time, how good do you think they are, and do they match up with those teams?
Well, they do with their size and their quickness, certainly, and with Bishop as their leader, they do. But right now, I still put Florida State and Michigan ahead of everybody. And Penn State surprised me. I thought Penn State was in that bunch. And last week just got shell-shocked.
Really never in that game
no,
at home.
Absolutely not. Yeah. Not even close.
Don't forget about Nebraska. They have barely won.
Well, and that's exactly the point I was going to. I was going to let you call the play. Then you look at Nebraska here, and Nebraska smacked Kansas State. Now, a lot of that is psychological. And there are those that say, well, Kansas State never beats Nebraska. And that's true. But the bottom line is they win year in and year out. They were dominant against this team, and they've been dominant against almost everybody except for Missouri. And that's still a miracle. When you get those things happening for you, you know you're destined to be someplace.
It may be fate. You're right. When that starts happening. I think Kansas State would love to get another crack at Nebraska, though. I think they've improved all year long.
But I think in a bowl, Florida State would still beat Michigan or Nebraska.
That's what we'll throw. Over the middle, he's got his tight end up at the 48-yard line. Number 86, Brody Hefner.
Obviously, that couldn't happen the way the bowl structure is. You know, they couldn't meet, but I just think Florida State with its quickness, and it's a young team with 34 freshmen on the roster. They're getting better every week.
That's the scary part.
Yeah, the defense is getting more dominant, and Busby's been sensational this year.
And even when Busby leaves, you got Dan Kendra, Chris Winkie, and those guys coming back next year. Hessler to throw again. Got his man, Cheverita, who's been quiet today, the leading receiver, onto the 33-yard line. Well, the Chevrolet Most Valuable Players of the Game for Colorado, Ryan Sutter, the free safety with 16 tackles on the afternoon, and Michael Bishop for Kansas State, 156 yards in the air and a touchdown, and he ran for 44 yards. Chevrolet will donate $1,000 to each school's general scholarship fund to reward outstanding students for their academic achievements and to assist those in financial need. It's been a Chevrolet tradition for more than a quarter of a century.
Unfortunately, the play that stood out with Sutter was the one where they scored a touchdown. But let me tell you, the guy is a hard-nosed, tough competitor. He averages 15 tackles a game, and he's right up there again.
Hessler on the run. Good throw to Savoy. He's got it inside the 10. And that is vintage John Hessler, and he's going to Savoy. You are absolutely right. This is the John Hessler that Colorado fans used to be used to.
Well, he's got the talent. I don't think anybody would dispute that, especially Rick Neuheisman. But it's got to be the 6 inches between his ears. I mean, somebody has to free that up, just let it go, and rely strictly on his athletic ability.
These fans don't want to give up another score. Hessler with all the time in the world to the end zone and overthrows Savoy. Troutman was there too.
You know, and Rick Neuheisel has to shoulder some of that, because as a coach, he's the one that has to free him up there mentally. And I think sometimes when you're too hard on a certain kind of guy, then they get a little bit tentative to start worrying about mistakes.
The best coaches will tell you maybe the top priority is knowing your players and what they respond to and what they don't respond to and how they react to you as a head coach.
Well, this drive right here is showing you what the kid can do.
And make no mistake, you're not going to win this, but he desperately wants to put something on the board to prove a point. Hessler to the end zone, jump ball through the hands of number 17, Robert Toler.
That ball should have been caught. That was a difficult throw all the way across the field. It was there and went through his hands, as you said. Toler had to go up and get it. It was high, but it was certainly catchable.
So 43 seconds left. And the Wildcat doesn't have a coat on. It's chilly up there.
He's worried about a coat on. Gosh, he's on the ledge there. That's dangerous.
Well, he's got to know what he's doing. He's at home.
Doesn't have a safety belt on. That's what I'd be worried about. Forget the coat.
It is windy. Third down for Hessler. The play clock running down. He got it off, though. Throws it up to Savoy.
hangs on. Was he in? Yes. Touchdown, Buffaloes. What a catch and what concentration by Phil Savoy.
And again, there's Hessler now throwing a touch pass right to the very corner of the end zone. I'm surprised they didn't go to Savoy earlier. Look how he just kind of throws this high. Doesn't put a hole on in. Now watch his feet. He only did 1 foot in. Again, he's working with the freshman. Oh, there's no question he made the catch. That is a great catch. He was in. I don't know what the crowd's yelling about and booing about.
And they're going to go for two once again. They went for two on the last drive after the touchdown, and Hessler ran it in. 37-20 is the score. Hessler this time wants to throw. Severini incomplete. Pushed out, never came in bounds.
2-point attempt is no good.
So Rick Neuheisel's team denied on the 2-point try. If it were early in the season, you say, well, they take something to build on, but it's too late in the season. Maybe you look at what might have been throughout the year.
How about this? This drive, he was 6-for-9, 79 yards. And the three he missed. One was catchable, and the other two he threw away. Plays on. Look at this guy. He's got on his sunglasses.
Bright lights in the stadium.
It's dark. It's snowing. It's 10 degrees. And he's got on sunglasses. Looks like he's in Miami.
Four banks of light. That's it. He's here in the stadium.
You think he's not banking on the Fiesta Bowl?
He's ready.
He won't even have to change clothes to go to Tempe.
Ah, it stops snowing. What the heck? Now, Wagner Field, KSU Stadium, much different atmosphere than there used to be here. They are excited. We talked to a Kansas State grad last night at dinner, said during his 4 years he never saw the Wildcats win a game.
Not one.
Not one game. How things have changed.
He said it was an upset if they were even close.
And actually, he was with Colorado fans who made sure he attended because they figured he was a jinx. They wanted him in this stadium. The onside kick again. Colorado may have it.
They got it.
They got it. 35 seconds left. It's a 17-point game.
Look at Rick Neuheisel. He's over there signaling that it's Colorado ball. He's still fighting.
So Rick Neuheisel's club came into this at 5-4. They go to 5-5. They still have one shot left at a bowl bid, but it comes against Nebraska.
You know, I'd go back in Boulder, and I would make the practices so much fun. Just let these guys bounce around, take the pressure off. You know, forget about the, you know, building this Nebraska thing. I'd just try to get these guys totally freed up, let them play to the best of their ability, and just roll the dice.
That matchup on November 28th in Boulder. 35 seconds left. Hessler to throw again. Incomplete. Bodie Hefner, the tight end, was right at the first down marker.
Incomplete. Defending on apply number 35, Deshaun Carter. Second down, 10, 45-yard line.
Colorado trips play. Set him deep. Throw it high.
Michigan knows all about it. Hessler going to throw it. Stiggers comes back. Incomplete. Good coverage from Dimitri Denmark, who actually thought he was interfered with, and now the flag comes out about 10 minutes later.
That's the latest flag I've seen this year.
Either that flag was stuck in the pocket of the official.
No, the linesman threw it. He came all the way down from midfield down to the 18 and threw the flag. offensive pass interference.
Marcus Stiggers step for step and actually behind Dimitri Denmark. And Denmark was motioning that way as soon as that ball hit the turf.
I'd like to be the side judge. The side judge sit back there right on the play. Doesn't throw a flag. Lineman come down, comes all the way down, runs 40 yards and drops the flag.
So we're down to 24 seconds, riding this one out. And again, trips to the near side for the Buffaloes. We'll see if they throw it up top once again. Rushes on Hessler this time. Tripp stays up, trying to get to the sideline and run out of bounds with a flag to boot. No give up in this kid in this offense.
That's exactly right, Terry. 37 to 20. You've got 15 and a half seconds left. And they're battling like it's the second play of the game.
They'll bring it back on the hold.
Holding. 20 out there. 10 yards down. 3 seconds down.
So Kansas State's going to go to 9-1. Colorado very disappointing this year. We'll go to 5-5 with one game left, one shot left at a bowl game, and that's against Nebraska.
Not the easiest of assignments.
Nebraska scored 63 points in the first half today.
Four straight bowl wins. The bowl opportunity could come to an end. Savoy can't reach it. A little bit behind him and underthrown. So 10 seconds left now.
Got to give Carter a lot of credit. He was on Savoy all day. We kept saying they weren't throwing to Savoy, but a lot of that could have been Carter. He had good coverage. He was battling all day. A freshman with a lot of confidence plays that corner. It gets awfully lonely out there. You know, that's like being a guy on an island, and when you miss an assignment or break down or somebody makes a catch over you, you're spotlighted. He's done a heck of a job today.
Played well, didn't he?
Good coach Stoops, a lot of credit too.
So he got trips again to the near side. Hessler looking over the middle though. So very caught, popped out, picked off by Sino. The tale of Colorado's day and Colorado's season. And the story for this Kansas State defense. Seminole with the interception to end the game. Well, that's how it is going. 37 to 20, the final score for the first time since 1984. Kansas State beats Colorado. For Tim Brandon, Lewis Johnson, I'm Terry Gannon, and hope you enjoyed it here in Manhattan. Tomorrow here on ABC, soccer action and then figure skating. So long, everybody.
And down at Redfield.
Oh, no. It's over. It's academic.
This has been a presentation of ABC Sports, recognized around the world as the leader in sports television.
There is a nuclear bomb heading towards our nation's capital.
How did this happen?
And the terrorist who planted it.
You made a fatal mistake.
Is one of our own.
Oh, God. Mayday, mayday.
Ooh. Medusa's Child. ABC Sunday.
Conversation makes a difference. Mentors listen and talk with children in need. Could be you. Children First. Connect with a kid in your area.
You're watching ABC.
Dodge Dakota owners are celebrating. A recent J.D. Power & Associates study ranked Dakota most appealing compact pickup. But we believe the price is pretty appealing, too. How do you add lots more muscle without breaking a sweat? Get a Magnum V6 at no extra charge when you buy a Dodge Dakota. So come, bulk up. at the friendly Dodge dealer near you.
We're remodeling and expanding. In order to do so, we need to get rid of some furniture. So we've marked everything down, and we're passing the savings on to you. This iron bed with wood post is 139 full-size, 149 queen, and 159 king. And this cast iron bed is 259 full-size, 269 queen, and 279 king. This iron bed with heirloom finish is 259 full, 279 queen, and 289 king. Nobody beats American. Nobody.
Pam and Sue just bought new contact lenses. Pam went to America's Best, Sue went somewhere else. For $49.99, Pam got not one, but two six-packs of SofMed disposables. Sue paid more for her brand. At America's Best, Pam's eye exam was included. Sue's exam cost $70 more. Two six-packs of contacts with exam, $49.99. Ought to call America's Best. Right, Sue?
Call today to schedule your appointment. Locations in Aurora, Littleton, and Arvada.
Genital herpes isn't just about worrying over future outbreaks. It's about suppressing them. And it's not only about waiting for an outbreak to begin treatment. It's about suppressing it ahead of time with Valtrex just once a day. Call this number to get product information for Valtrex and a free trial coupon. Remember, even if you don't have symptoms and are on suppressive therapy, it may be possible to spread herpes to others. There is no cure for genital herpes, and Valtrex may not prevent all recurrences. If your immune system is not normal because of advanced HIV disease, bone marrow, or kidney transplant, make sure your doctor knows this to avoid a potentially serious complication. In studies, the most common side effect was headache. See our ad in Life magazine. Don't wait. Call this number today and ask your doctor about Valtrex. It's about suppression.
Colorado is spinning the wheel.
All this week at 6:30 on 7 News.
I deserve to know why he died and how he spent his last hours alive.
A tearful plea from the grandmother of a young Adams County boy. 8-year-old Danielle Ramirez is dead, and police say the boy's mother is to blame. Good evening, I'm Susan Parks.
Thanks for joining us, I'm Ann Trujillo. We start with a 7 News exclusive. A jury may have to decide if a woman's religious beliefs led to the death of her 8-year-old son. Did those beliefs keep her from giving him a life-saving shot of insulin? Almost 3 months after the death of Daniel Ramirez, his mother, Rebecca, has been charged with child abuse resulting in death. 7 News reporter Steve Saunders joins us from the newsroom with more. Steve?
Well, Ann, even still after all this time, there is a lot we do not know about Daniel's death. Now, Rebecca Ramirez is out of jail on $50,000 bond. She says in the days before Daniel died, he was sick because of something he had eaten. Well, doctors disagree, and there is a lot of evidence that Rebecca made a conscious decision to stop giving Daniel the insulin he so desperately needed.
The last time I saw him was on his birthday party that I had given him here on June 28th. The next time I saw him, he was in the coffin.
In the early morning hours of Wednesday, August 20th, paramedics rushed to this Adams County apartment complex where they found 8-year-old Daniel Ramirez dead. He had died perhaps several hours earlier because he had not been given his insulin.
How does a mother who has given her child shots twice a day for 4 years all of a sudden stop giving him his shots?
Perhaps because Daniel's mother thought his diabetes had been cured by God. This past summer, Rebecca Ramirez began attending church at the Disciple Fellowship in North Denver, which believes in the healing power of prayer and touch. Rebecca took Daniel to church on Sunday, August 17th. Investigators later found a calendar in her home on which the words "Daniel healed" had been written for that date. On the logbook that tracked Daniel's insulin shots, detectives found this entry for that same date: no shots, comments, healed, 817. The next day's entry reads in part, blood glucose 360, no shots. Doctors say with the glucose level that high, Daniel should have immediately been given a dose of insulin.
People get healed in church, but common sense would tell you, you don't stop taking medicine or giving your child medicine.
Sandy Ramirez was raised in the Pentecostal religion and believes people can be healed. Still, she fears that a misguided faith killed her grandson and is now glad that criminal charges have been filed. She hopes a trial will answer her questions.
Until this all is settled and we find out why he died, why she withheld his insulin, then I know that I can bury him in peace.
Almost 3 months have passed since Daniel's death. He was Sandy's only grandchild.
I have this reoccurring nightmare that it's just dark and I hear him calling me and I can't find him.
Now, still another unanswered question is, why did it take so long for Rebecca to call for help? She told police she had talked to Daniel not long before dialing 911. Coroners, however, Ann, say he may have been dead for anywhere from 2 to 4 hours.
And what do church leaders say?
Well, we stopped by the church today and left word that we wanted to talk with Pastor Paul Schell. He has not gotten back to us at this point. However, he did, during the investigation, tell police that he has never told anyone in the congregation that while he does believe in the healing process, the power of God, that they should stop taking their medication without talking to their doctors. He said he was not even aware that Daniel had a problem with diabetes.
Oh, very tragic case. All right. Thanks, Steve. Denver police still searching at this hour for a fifth person who investigators say may have been involved in this week's shooting that killed a Denver police officer. Officer Bruce Vanderjagt was killed in a shootout Wednesday afternoon at the Monaco Place Apartments. Three people are in custody. Dion Gerza, Demetria Soriano, and Liesl Allman were all arrested in connection with the case. They all face second-degree burglary charges. Allman also faces assault and felony menacing charges. She was the only one of the three at the apartments when the shooting happened. Another man, Matthias Janig, was there too. He shot and killed Officer Vanderjagt, then killed himself. Last night, 7 News talked exclusively with a bounty hunter who tried to serve an arrest warrant at Janig's house. He says Janig lived a bizarre lifestyle and was feared even by his friends.
You thought you were in a devil's den, or it was a cult house. I mean, very dark, very private. Each room was quarantined off. Each person had their own section of the house.
Lucero says he remembers seeing satanic symbols, candles, and witches' paraphernalia as a woman led him through the Janig mansion. Janig's family disputes claims that he was racist or satanic. Janig's mother says she wants to send a letter to Officer Vanderjagt's widow, letting her know how sorry she is for the deadly shooting.
President Clinton is banning imports of foreign-made semi-automatic assault weapons, guns like the one that killed Officer Vanderjagt. At a press conference earlier this week, Denver Police Chief David Michaud showed a gun similar to the one that killed Officer Vanderjagt. It's a Chinese-made SKS assault rifle. You can legally buy a weapon like this for about $200. Now, Mr. Clinton made the announcement in his radio address today, saying weapons like these do nothing but, quote, inspire fear and wreak deadly havoc on our streets.
Tensions remain high between the U.S. and Iraq after Saddam Hussein defies a U.N. order and kicks American weapons inspectors out of the country. Tonight, Iraq is acting like a country expecting a military attack, and the U.S. isn't ruling one out. 7 News reporter Jim Williams has the latest.
Fighter planes are taking off around the clock from the USS Nimitz in the Persian Gulf. Prepare to use force if Iraq violates a no-fly zone.
If there was a no-flight violation, we would certainly enforce the sanctions. Now, what does that mean, shooting them down? I would say probably yes.
The Nimitz will soon be joined by the USS George Washington. But such American military might is failing to persuade Iraq to allow U.S. participation on United Nations weapons inspection teams. As Iraqi citizens demonstrate in support of their leaders, Iraq's foreign minister again warned his nation would shoot down U.S. U-2 spy planes expected to fly soon over Iraq. U.S. Secretary of State Madeleine Albright called threats of war from Iraq highly irresponsible.
Threatening us or anyone else is not the answer here.
Albright plans visit Sunday to Saudi Arabia, Kuwait, and Bahrain to discuss the crisis, but not, the State Department says, to ask for a U.S. military buildup in those nations. President Clinton on the West Coast for environmental events reportedly called British Prime Minister Tony Blair to strengthen unity on the U.N. Security Council. Meantime, on Capitol Hill, Republicans are supporting Mr. Clinton.
With the administration consulting Congress, I am confident we'll support the president in taking strong action against Saddam Hussein's efforts to produce chemical weapons and other weapons of mass destruction.
For now, the Clinton administration says military action against Iraq is not imminent. But there were tearful goodbyes as U.S. ships left Norfolk, Virginia for a previously scheduled mission in the Persian Gulf. Jim Williams, ABC News, Washington.
Now, former President George Bush dealt with Saddam during the Persian Gulf War. He had some tough talk in Houston last night for his former foe.
I think it's a big mess, and we better stay strong. This guy's a liar. He's violating international law, and I don't like it that we don't have our allies with us, but I'm sure the president's trying to do what he can in that regard. But we better not look weak. This man only understands one thing, and that's strength.
And yet another tense situation abroad for the U.S. The bodies of four American oil company workers killed in Pakistan are being flown home today. The Americans apparently were slain in retaliation for the murder conviction of a Pakistani man in Virginia. More violence is threatened now that a Pakistani man has been sentenced to death for killing two CIA employees.
Hundreds of people visiting the Preparedness Expo in Denver this weekend, but the survival gear is being overshadowed by a man connected to the most infamous crime in America, the brother of Oklahoma City bombing suspect Terry Nichols. James Nichols is at the expo promoting his self-published book, Freedom's End: Conspiracy in Oklahoma. It's about the government raid on his home in Michigan and his own investigation of the Oklahoma City bombing. Nichols is keeping close tabs on his brother's trial.
His life is on the line. I'm concerned. We're all concerned. Many people here at this expo are concerned. They're all hoping and praying that he gets exonerated, just as we do. It's because everyone believes him to be innocent.
Many Oklahoma City families might disagree, but James Nichols' views are clear, even on his T-shirt that says Terry wasn't there.
If you've lived in Colorado for some time, you may recall on this day 10 years ago the deadly crash of Continental Flight 1713. Many of the 82 people on board were flying home for Thanksgiving when the jet crashed on takeoff during a snowstorm at Stapleton Airport. 27 people were killed. Today, Paul Vermeulen, one of the survivors, took a rose to the cemetery for a fellow employee who died in the crash.
But as the plane was starting to go down, Diana and I looked eye to eye at each other, and we knew in a split second that we were going down. And come to find out later, after being in a hospital, that she had died, and knowing that really I was the last one to see her alive, and I'm the last vision she had before she was killed, there was an instant bond.
Investigators determined that wind shear and ice played a role in the crash. The flight was destined for Boise when it crashed on takeoff.
So, are you making plans for your Thanksgiving dinner yet? Well, if you're swamped, our Gabby Gourmet has some help in the kitchen coming up.
The sun's out, but that didn't help temperatures much today. How long will this cold go on? Pam is next with the forecast.
Also, crowds flock to the Denver Art Museum's grand reopening. We'll show you some of the new paintings.
And speaking of pictures, pets get their photos taken with Santa today. All the doggone details a little later on.